Now, said he is going to try and kick in this ball game to see how it works out. If it does not work out, then Bennett, the punter, is going to have to punt. Darren Bennett, number two, he works out kicking, just kicking the football once a week. And if he has to kick, everything is a question mark. Al?
All right, thank you, Lynn. Jeff Jaeger to kick off now for the Oakland Raiders, whose every game this season is a road game since the team continues to train in Southern California. They fly to their home games. They fly to their road games. This was an easy one, only 120 miles. Jaeger with a deep kick fielded at the goal line by rookie Terrell Fletcher. And the former Wisconsin Badger brings it back up to the 30-yard line. The ball comes loose at the end of the play. And it is recovered by San Diego. It was a loose ball and recovered by San Diego. Fletcher comes up with the football himself. Now Stan Humphries taking over. Stan, who guided the Chargers into the Super Bowl last year, originally drafted by the Washington Redskins. Rodney Culver is their running back. Papunu and Young are the tight ends. Martin and Jefferson are the wideouts. Up front, Swain, Moulton, Hall, Cocuzzo, and Parker. Natron Means not suited tonight, again missing another game because of a groin pull. Humphries throws, the catch is made by Dwayne Young for a short gain. Gain of one, it'll be second down and nine. The Raiders play a base 4-3. Anthony Smith, Nolan Harrison back in the lineup. He's missed 2 months. McLaughlin, the other tackle, and Pat Swilling having a fine year. Fredrickson, Beekert, and Jones are the linebackers. Great corners in McDaniel and Lewis, and the safeties are Hoskins and Anderson. Second and nine, San Diego from the 31-yard line. And they give it to Rodney Culver. He picks up about three and is taken back by three Raiders led by Mike Jones and Greg Beekert. Well, it's the Raiders and the Chargers, and right off the bat, a mini scrum.
And, you know, a side note here, there's Natron Means over on the Charger sideline, but Nolan Harrison, who's starting a defensive tackle tonight for the Raiders, as you said, Jerry Ball out. But he got hurt in the San Diego game at the beginning of the season. He thought it was an illegal block. Eric Moten and Courtney Hall, the left guard and center respectively. So there is some bad blood coming into this game between the Raiders on the defensive line and the Chargers on their offensive line. I don't think that's the last skirmish of the evening.
Third down and six from the 34-yard line. Harmon split to the right. And Harmon over the middle, and the pass is incomplete at the 40-yard line. There is a marker down, though. Rob Fredrickson covering on the play.
Right away, we can see the bulk of the offense for San Diego is going to be in the hands of Ronnie Harmon. Without Natron Means, a near 1,400-yard rusher a year ago, he's out, and apparently there is no penalty. They pick up the flag, and it is fourth down.
He picked it up. The flag came out, and it was picked up.
Well, how do you not? How do you not throw the flag on that thing? Fredrickson draped all over Harmon.
He was right the first time.
There was a flag thrown, and it was picked up, and Bennett launches one to the 11-yard line. Tim Brown finds some room, and it's a good run back for Brown up to the 31-yard line. That kick, 56 yards. And Brown runs it back 20 yards. Vince Evans made his National Football League debut as a Chicago Bear. Graduate of the University of Southern California, was a Bear in 1977. Harvey Williams in the backfield with Kerry Cash and Glover starting at the tight end spots. Ismael and Brown are the wideouts. Jenkins, Wisniewski, Turk, Gogan, and Skrepanak, the offensive front. First down from the 31-yard line. They line Glover up in the backfield, number 87, along with Harvey Williams. And Williams is taken down immediately by Chris Mims. So the Chargers come out fired up defensively as we take a look at their front four, with Mims on one side, O'Neal on the other, and Lee and Davis in the middle. Then the linebackers, and the key man there would be Junior Seau. Dan talked about the death of Griggs. Bush taking that spot on the outside, and Gibson the other backer. Harper and the rookie Terran Shaw are the corners. Gale, the ex-Chicago Bear, and Orlando, the ex-Houston Oiler, are the safeties. The clock did not start. That's why we have a momentary stoppage here. The referee is Ed Hockley. And they want to make sure the game clock is in working order. We're a minute and a half into the game. Second down and 13 from the 28-yard line. Harvey Williams takes the toss up past the 30 and to the 35-yard line. It'll be third down and 6. Dwayne Harper up from a corner to make the tackle.
This is what the Raiders hope to do, and that is run the football. Every team comes in hoping to run the football, but the Raiders have been running it very well, with Harvey Williams averaging over 4.5 yards a carry and young Napoleon Coffin 5 yards per carry. But they're going against the San Diego defense that's 21st in the league against the rush. A year ago, San Diego was 5th against the rush, and that is a big part of their problem all year long. They just cannot stop the run.
You look through the mask of Seau. It's third down and 6. They send Williams in motion as the Raiders give the Chargers a new look here. And the catch is made by Darrell Hobbs for a first down. Hobbs, their third wide receiver, comes in these types of situations, third and 6, and that's why he converts. Terrence Shaw, the rookie from Stephen F. Austin State, making the tackle.
Just a little move over the middle to pick up yardage for the first down. A slap at it by the rookie from Stephen F. Austin. Terrence Shaw tried to strip it, didn't get it. First down Raiders.
Hostetler looks on. Evans, first and 10 up at the 42. No score. A little more than 3 minutes into the game. Harvey Williams looks for leverage up past the 45. And is tackled in front of the San Diego bench at the 49-yard line. Gain of about 7. Orlando and Shaw in on the stop.
We talked about the Raiders and they're wanting to run the football. I don't think they're going to be very fancy about it either. They're going to run on first down. They just assume the Chargers know it's coming. This is as simple as a play gets, just a simple toss to Harvey Williams. And look at that. When you start picking up 8 yards on first down, you're not only running a very effective offense, you're serving notice on the defense. It's almost on the, it's sending a notice that you're out to humiliate them, and that's what the Chargers have to fight.
Second and 3, swing pass to Williams, and Harvey has the first down before he's taken out of bounds by Harper. You caught a shot of Kaufman before the play with his helmet on. He spells Williams, but you could see Napoleon at any time. Forget the third or fourth series, he could be in at any point in this drive.
That's one of the best spell running backs I've seen in a long time to come into this league. Napoleon Kaufman, if you haven't seen him, I know we'll see him a little later. He has got a great move to the outside. He can really get the Raiders on the outside. He spins back to the inside, and one of the finest moves I've seen come into this league in a lot of years.
That's the Rocket Ismael in motion on first down from the 45. They go to the right side with Harvey Williams. And he picks up 5 yards before Harper takes him out of bounds at the 40-yard line.
Just the mirror image of the last time Harvey ran the ball. He took it left. This time he takes it to the right. Good surge by the Raiders on their offensive line, but too easy to get around the corner. Chargers all pinned to the inside. Seau pinned to the inside. Skrepanek out front making a good block. Tim Brown wisely coming off. This was one of their least effective plays on first down, and they picked up a good solid 5.
Hoffman's in the game. It is second down and 5. The rookie from Washington, the fake toss to Kaufman, and a pass to Kaufman, and Napoleon has a first down. He's inside the 30, run out of bounds by Seau at the 28-yard line. And with Hostetler in civvies, Evans took his first shot of the night as he released that pass from Reuben Davis.
But a good read by Evans, looking downfield, sees the coverage, flips it out to Kaufman. Kaufman, pretty good receiver at Washington. He ran the ball so much, nearly 1,400 yards as a senior. He was not used that much as a receiver, but he had 22 receptions as a senior. He can do it all.
That was Evans' one previous start this year after Hostetler was forced to miss a game because of a bruised larynx. And Evans responded. Pass to Derek Fenner. Good move. He faked Gibson out of his pants, and Harper finally makes the tackle inside the 20-yard line.
This is a very impressive start for the Raiders offensively, using a myriad of different people. They're allowing everyone to get involved offensively here in their initial drive. Mike White has a lot of weapons, and why not give it to everybody? You know, Vince Evans, who's really known for having a nice touch on the ball going deep, that time side arms it perfectly to Fenner, allows him to catch it in full stride. Good start for the Raiders.
First and 10 at the 13. Ninth play of the drive. Harvey Williams takes it to the 9. Mike White is one of those coaches who likes to script the first 15 plays of the game so far. This script is on its way to an Oscar.
At least the bestseller. There's Jim Fassel. He calls the plays from up on high. Came over from Denver. Been there a couple of years before that with the Giants.
A little more experience there in Joe Bugel.
And wonders with this offensive line. It's thin, but it's very good.
I got one recommendation. When they get to 15, I go back to number one again.
Yeah, you start working your way back.
I think I might have this a loop just over and over.
Just do a sequel. Second down and 7 at the 10-yard line.
Opening drive 2.
Well, they finally stop them as the Chargers penetrate, and Harvey Williams is tackled back on the line of scrimmage at the 12-yard line. Dave Adolph, the defensive coordinator, formerly with Kansas City
and the Raiders,
first year, and the Raiders, and took over for the retired Bill Arnsparger, hired by Coach Bobby Ross.
And ostensibly to give the San Diego Chargers a more attacking-type defense. However, they come in ranked 15th in the league, and much of that has to do with the loss of David Griggs, who was so tough against the run in that tragic automobile accident in the offseason. The big Sam linebacker that they lost, that has really hurt them defensively. Third down and 9. No score in the first quarter. Evans throws, and it's incomplete. Glover, the intended receiver. Mims pins Evans as Vince stepped up. The initial coverage was outstanding, and Mims and Lee both bury Evans, who has grass on the side of his helmet, and in comes the field goal unit.
And a monster job of stiffening up by the Chargers defensively. They were giving every indication of allowing the Raiders to come right down the field and score a touchdown, and to recover the way they have and force Jaeger into a field goal attempt is as good a recovery as you could hope for San Diego.
30-yard attempt, Jeff Gossett to hold. The two Jeffs have worked together for a long time. So Evans guides them into field goal position. Jaeger converts, and Oakland leads 3-0.
Ford introduces the all-new Taurus, where every curve flows into an ingenious new design, where one-of-a-kind ideas unfold, where everything you touch is soft on your fingertips, and even the back seat shows forward thinking. The all-new Ford Taurus.
For years, I dreamed of seeing Venice with my boyfriend, Tom. I'd whisper about palazzos, gondolas.
All he'd talk about is deadlines and business meetings.
Finally, I went and booked 2 romantic weeks on the Grand Canal with my Visa Gold card. Tom was completely surprised.
Scusa, chi è questo Tom?
Visa Gold. Purchase power to make dreams come true. It's everywhere you want to be.
If you got a beard, we've got your number. The adjustable Maverick Beard and Mustache Trimmer with 6 different settings. Man, does this do a number on beards. Maverick from Norelco.
How does it feel to be Steve Young? It hurts. Give me my Advil. Nothing has shown me it works better on aching muscles or lasts longer. Advil is the one. Nasty game.
Advanced medicine for pain.
Back in San Diego at Jack Murphy Stadium, a gorgeous night. Oakland leading 3-0 with 8 minutes and 1 second to play in the first quarter. The Goodyear blimp Eagle soaring in the skies above Southern California.
I guess you could call this a perfect night for football.
Absolutely.
Not perfect for Andre Coleman, the talented wide receiver and return specialist for the Chargers. He got banged up last week in their game in Denver. It hurt his chest and his ribs. Had a problem with his kidney from the severity of the blow and has to sit this one out. And this is where the Chargers feel his loss.
And that's why Fletcher runs this kick back. escapes a couple of tackles inside the 10-yard line, brings it back to the 17. Coleman last week at Denver ran one back 91 yards for a touchdown.
Dad?
Yeah?
There's something I want to tell you.
What is it, son?
Well, Dad, you're my dad. And I love you, man.
You're not getting my Bud Light, Johnny.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Ray, forget it, Johnny.
I'm in this carpool where everybody wants to drive.
Your turn to drive
my car. Because everyone agrees that my Ford Contour handles like nothing else.
Now drive.
Driving, okay, you're driving.
Yeah.
Can you believe it? But when they find out it's loaded with things like air conditioning, rear window defrost, air filtration system, and a stereo cassette for a great low price, they'll get their own. And our carpool will be a convoy.
Emma, seems like we've known each other forever.
Yeah, I know. 2 weeks.
Will you marry me? Because, Emma, I love you, man.
Oh, Johnny, you're not getting my Bud Light.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down.
Johnny?
Make it a Bud Light.
Jane?
It's Joan.
Jane, Joan, whatever. I feel like I've known you forever.
Finally, a show that puts the world of the unexplained to the test. Get the scientific facts on supernatural phenomena, ghosts, mediums, and psychics put to the test Thursday on ABC.
ABC's Monday Night Football is being brought to you by Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Dr. Pepper is just what the doctor ordered. The all-new Ford Taurus, a look you've never seen for a name you know well. And Bud Light, if you want great taste that won't fill you up and never lets you down, make it a Bud Light. The Chargers trailing 3-0, first down from the 17. Humphreys gives the ball to Rodney Culver, and Greg Beekert, the middle linebacker, is right there to stop him back at the line of scrimmage.
They beat us there Monday night.
Stop by number 54, Greg Beekert.
There's Greg Beekert in the middle, number 54. It's just a simple read. That's not a run blitz or anything of the sort. He's just reading the fullback up the middle, and somebody on that offensive line has to account for it. That's just shoddy blocking up front.
Second and 11, and this is Culver behind a Patunu block, but there's Beekert again. He's really coming into his own. Third year out of Colorado, playing better and better, and filling the middle beautifully and doing a great job from the backside.
Something tells me we're going to get another look at Mr. Beekert. This is more of a read and react, but it's okay. One of the things that he does really well from the middle linebacker. He flows. Everything for a middle linebacker here is when to go upfield. Which hole do I pick and how quickly can I get upfield? A lot of middle linebackers choose poorly. They go upfield, and then when the back goes outside, they can't make the play. A good burst there by Beekert to make the tackle.
Third and 11, flags are down. Humphreys with a hard count and throws a wobbly duck toward Jefferson. Stand with those hunched shoulders. Ed Hockley is the referee. The line judge makes this call, and it's offside against Oakland, so that hard count worked. John Fox, the defensive coordinator, saying, come on. Should make a better call than that.
Offside by the defense. The right defensive end. The 5-yard penalty with 2 third down.
Swilling.
Well, you hate to give him another shot after you forced him to punt, and that's what happens with an incomplete pass on third down. Here's Pat, the second guy in, number 56. He just falls forward just enough to get his helmet into that neutral zone. And let's see now if the Chargers can capitalize. They go to three wides.
Humphreys will draw them off a lot. He's got a very good hard count. Got away with it there. Third down and 6 from the 21-yard line. Stan going deep. And a catch is made by Sean Jefferson. Great catch at the 44 of Oakland.
Beautifully thrown ball. That was pretty good coverage by Albert Lewis. One of your fine people in man coverage and limping off is Sean Jefferson. But Bobby Humphrey loves to hang one up.
Jefferson comes limping off.
Just strictly man for man with Albert Lewis on a sprint, looking into the eyes of Jefferson trying to time the read. Could have even drawn a flag with that left hand getting in there, pulling on the right arm, but it was a good catch by Jefferson.
That's interference all the way by Albert Lewis as he does get a hold of Jefferson's right arm. Excellent concentration by Jefferson.
Now Humphreys throws, Harmon makes the catch, and he's hit immediately and pushed back and tackled by Rob Fredrickson.
One thing about Albert Lewis, guys, is the way he plays out there on the corner in his 13th year on the league. If he's going to lock up on a receiver, he's got to get a hit at the line of scrimmage. Mm-hmm. He's not going to run with Jefferson and people like that without making some kind of a hit at the line. Here's Harmon and Fredrickson. Pretty good hit by Fredrickson and knocks Harmon back. He doesn't go down, but boy, he stays with him and makes the tackle.
And not lost in San Diego as they're trying to cover Harmon with the linebacker.
San Diego needs Jefferson back in his ballgame.
He's still trying to shake it off, and here's Harmon. And he gets taken down by Anthony Smith, who stays right with him and makes the tackle back at the 44-yard line, and that will make it third down and 10.
Boy, you can see Sean Jefferson still limping as he comes back out onto the field. Now that's either a guy who's really trying to play through a lot of pain, or a guy setting up a cornerback. We'll find out here.
After he's already beat Lewis once, he'll be on him once again. Lewis couldn't care if he was coming out there limping on both feet.
Let's see how Sean gets off the ball.
Third and 10, the two of them locked up at the top. Lewis gives him a little pop. Pass is intended for Jefferson, and Anderson comes in and hits him.
Well, that time it was not single coverage, it was double coverage. Lewis playing the underneath zone, and Eddie Anderson timed that hit and really collided with Jefferson. These two safeties, Derek Hoskins and Eddie Anderson, they'll hit as hard as any two safeties in the league. Now Lewis lets him go. Humphreys reads it right here as his own. So too does Jefferson, but here comes Anderson with a good shot.
Injury timeout.
Ford introduces the all-new Taurus. For those who want to have it all and take it all with them. For those who have an eye for design and a passion for performance. And for those who want the latest in safety, including standard dual airbags and available anti-lock brakes. The all-new Ford Taurus wagon. For those whose dreams are a little bigger.
Making the dream come true.
There are two kinds of people in the world. Those who say they'll get around to it. And those who actually do. To those who've discovered there's greater satisfaction in putting things up than in putting them off, we present VersaPack from Black & Decker, a rechargeable battery system that powers an entirely new line of cordless tools. From now on, it's how things get done.
Radio Shack. The Florida Gators take on Arkansas with bowl bids on the line. It's the SEC Championship game presented by Dr. Pepper Saturday on ABC's College Football.
There is the hitter in Eddie Anderson, and there is the hit-ee in Sean Jefferson, who's been working hard trying to get the feeling back in his right arm. Stan Humphreys was late in the throw, and then he stretched him out, and really, that's the type of a throw that gets your receivers killed. And Sean Jefferson nearly was by Eddie Anderson.
Darren Bennett floats one toward Tim Brown, who calls for the fair catch and makes it at the 15-yard line. Raiders will take over for the second time in the game at that spot. 4 minutes and 19 seconds to play in the opening quarter in San Diego, where the Raiders lead the Chargers 3-0. We'll be right back.
Welcome to the greatest air connections of the past 25 years, brought to you by Southwest Airlines, celebrating its 25th anniversary. Southwest Airlines, the low-fare airline. With visions of touchdowns dancing in his eyes, Anthony Miller's dreams came true as he connected with quarterback Stan Humphries for two touchdowns in what was a Monday night nightmare for the Dolphins.
Humphries, deep drop, they blitz, they pick it up, goes to the back of the end zone, and Miller caught it! Touchdown!
Gotta goes come in two kinds. Not so good.
That tooth has gotta go.
And good.
Got the flowers, Mark. Now, when are you sending you?
Well, for the good kind, Southwest Airlines has gotta go fares from $19 on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays.
I'm real lonely.
But hurry, because the going isn't always this good.
Mom, I gotta go!
Southwest, the low-fare airline.
I'm 54 years old, and I still eat Kellogg's Frosted Flakes.
Brave adults challenge the notion that Frosted Flakes cereal is just for kids.
I eat them, and I love them. There. What's so hard about that? This is only going to be seen late at night, right? Oops.
Dolores, has anybody seen Dolores? Oh, never mind.
The sweet crunch of Kellogg's Frosted Flakes have the taste adults have grown to love. They're great.
I love him. Don't you just love him?
Thursday, the commish is back in an all-new movie.
He did not kill Tarbell.
Tony's gotta catch a killer before the wrong man is executed. Dean Stockwell guests on the commish in the Shadow of the Gallows Thursday.
Beautiful sight in the middle of Mission Valley.
The Murph.
San Diego Jack Murphy Stadium.
Should do every game here.
At least a few. The Raiders on top 3-0, taking over for the second time at the 15-yard line. Vince Sevens at the age of 40 with Napoleon Kaufman at the age of 22 behind him. And Evans throws, and it is through the hands of Derek Fenner, covered by Harper. The oldest quarterback to ever start a National Football League game was Earl Morrill, at that time playing with Miami in 75. George Blando would have been next in 68. Len Dawson third. He was 4 days older than Evans, so Evans will move into the number three spot if he starts next week against Kansas City. There's the Fabulous Five right there with Johnny Unitas rounding out the top five. Kaufman. And Napoleon picks up 13. A lot of people might say, well, what about Blanda in 1970 when he had all of those miracle comebacks and was kicking all of those field goals? George, 2 years older in 70, obviously, than in 68, but never started the game that year.
Well, and the other side of that is that three of those five are Hall of Famers. The other four were all full-time regular quarterbacks. What's really unusual about it is that Vince Evans has been a career backup quarterback. A couple different stints where he wasn't even in the National Football League. And it is really to his credit that he is still not just around, but he's a major contributor in the NFL.
Here's Harvey Williams threading his way through the middle, takes it up to the 33, tackled by Junior Seau.
And I think the extraordinary thing is that he has never been hurt in this game, Ed. He is a fine athlete. He'll take off and run with the football, and he's a good runner, always has been. And I'm quite sure that they have put in some kind of a semi-role, maybe a moving pocket for him, getting something to the outside, giving him an option to either run or throw the football. He's had an opportunity to take all the snaps this week. With Hostetler, they knew he wasn't going to play, rather than 10%, which he ordinarily would have. So he comes into this game fully loaded.
Second and seven from the 32. Puts it on his hip. Good play fake to buy time. And then he's necktied, and a flag goes down. Tackled at the 33 by Reuben Davis. Mike White finally getting an opportunity to be a head coach in the National Football League at the age of 59.
Holding by the offense number 66. The 10-yard penalty, repeat second down.
Kevin Gogan.
Raiders drawing another penalty, second from the left. And 66, Gogan on the hold call. The Raiders the most penalized team in the game. They had 13 penalties last week against Dallas.
Can't argue with that call. He had Sean Lee wrapped up pretty well.
Second and 17 from the 22-yard line. Kaufman
And the Washington rookie takes it up to the 29-yard line, tackled there by the linebacker Lewis Bush.
Well, you just get the feeling that every time Napoleon Kaufman squirts past the front seven, and there's Dennis Gibson, their inside linebacker, down on the ground. Of course, everybody remembers Gibson and the play he made in the AFC Championship game last year to send the Chargers to the Super Bowl. And right now he's being attended to by the Charger medical staff. We'll be back in a minute.
When can FedEx deliver these boxes?
Well, they said they could deliver them by 8 a.m. tomorrow.
That's great.
Or by 10:30 tomorrow.
Uh-huh.
Or on Monday by 8, 10:30 or 3.
Or same day.
Valentine's Day. Groundhog Day. On Saturday. Or even today. Oh, I forgot. By 4:30.
Now, with same day 8 a.m. and 10:30 delivery, no one gives you more delivery options than FedEx.
Hey, when can FedEx deliver those boxes?
Gloria?
Well, they could get it there by 8 a.m. or by
FedEx. Absolutely, positively, anytime.
Hi, sweetie.
What are you doing?
Playing the magic school bus.
Oh. Who is that?
That's Mr. Frizzle. Okay. Now we're going underwater. He's the kelp forest.
Giant kelp grows as fast as 1 foot in a day.
You know, pull it down, you make different sounds of animals, like the dolphin. You just put your hand on it.
Yeah.
And click that thing. Hit the fish.
Where?
Right there.
Oh, I see.
Tomorrow night, it's the best Tuesday night on television. The primetime lineup right here on ABC, beginning with Roseanne, then Hudson Street. Tony Danza involved with that one. Home Improvement, Coach with Craig T. Nelson and Shelley Fabre and the gang. And NYPD Blue coming your way tomorrow night right here on ABC.
This is the week we're not on, Coach, correct?
Not yet. I guarantee you we'll let everybody know. Dennis Gibson out. Glenn Young is in. That's Young at linebacker now. It's third and 10 for Oakland after the timeout. A little swing pass to Kaufman. Up past the 35, and he's very close to a first down, but he's short by a yard. Glenn Young makes the stop at the 38, fourth and one.
Boy, and it looks to me like Napoleon Kaufman was going to pick up that first down, and that was a tackle by Young that sent Kaufman backwards. Talk about a pressure play by a linebacker just in for Dennis Gibson. An outstanding open field tackle by Glenn Young. Napoleon Kaufman has all the momentum moving forward. Watch the stick by Young. Also the hit by Bo Orlando. Between the two of them, they send Kaufman going backwards, and you got to give Bo Orlando a lot of credit there, too. He came in and put the shoulder on him. Chargers needed that.
Jeff Gossett to punt. Terrell Fletcher back to receive again with Coleman out. It's Fletcher, the rookie from Wisconsin. Short kick, fielded on the run at the 28. And Fletcher takes it back to the 37-yard line. Kerry Cash makes the tackle. That was the 900th punt of Gossett's career. Next week, we head to the Silver Dome, the wild and wacky NFC Central, where the Chicago Bears coming off their three-point win over the Giants yesterday, and the Detroit Lions coming off their Thanksgiving Day win over Minnesota. Lock up from the Silver Dome next Monday night. The Bears and the Lions, a good one. Detroit's won three in a row.
Well, you tell Wayne Fonts you got to win.
Yeah,
you win.
And he wins.
How's San Diego running the ball so far?
Where's Natron?
Not very well.
This is Aaron Hayden.
There you go.
Rookie, and you ask, when are they going to start running the ball? Ask and we shall receive. The rookie from Tennessee, and he is exhorted by Natron Means.
Well, update that graphic. You can wipe that zero out.
Hayden's really a good story. Broke his leg as a senior a year ago, and Chargers took him in the fourth round, and they nursed him through training camp through the first part of the season. He just now is healthy. He was over 1,000-yard rusher for Tennessee.
Just activated a couple of weeks ago, and now he stop back of the line of scrimmage. Greg Beekert, who's had a very active first quarter, makes the stop. 28 seconds remaining in the quarter and the clock running.
Wasn't just your average broken leg either, Frank. No. It was an extremely serious injury. They had to put all sorts of pins and rods in there, and a real gamble by Bobby Beathard to take him in the fourth round. It's a pretty high draft choice for a guy really where there's a question mark whether or not he's ever going to be able to play anywhere nearly as effective as he did in college.
A typical Bobby Beathard gamble. He did that with Stan Humphries when he was with the Redskins.
End of the quarter, the Raiders lead the Chargers 3-0. Monday Night Football resumes after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Would we claim the Norelco razor shaves closer than ever without hundreds of tests to back it up? Say our precision groove helps the Norelco lift and cut system shave closer without proof? No. We wouldn't say it's our closest shave ever without science, sensors, tests. But of all the tests that prove it's closer, the most convincing requires a personal touch. The Norelco razor, our closest shave ever.
Every few years, the world gathers to witness an unparalleled sports spectacle, the Truckathlon. And to compete, you have to have a Ford Ranger 4x4, because you'll need a switch-on four-wheel drive for truck long jump. It's four-wheel anti-lock brakes for truck discus. And it's whopping 4-liter V6 for truck hurdles. The Ford Ranger 4x4. You can't win without one.
Next event, truck pole vault.
Yes!
This is ABC.
You'll never need to wrestle with your Christmas tree again. Just ask for the swivel straight stand at Gottschalk's.
Your tree will be up and straight in 60 seconds. Insert the tree trunk into the receptacle. Tighten down the screws and insert the receptacle into the stand.
Adjust the pedal to straighten the tree. Then retract the pedal for safety. What could be easier?
Swivel straight stands with lifetime guarantee. Just $59.99 at Gottschalk's.
BMXers winners at national competitions, but not at home. The story after the game.
We start the second quarter in San Diego. Al Michaels with Frank Gifford, Dan Dierdorf, and Lynn Swan. The Raiders lead the Chargers 3-0. Get your shopping done early. That's a reminder. It's second down and 11 at the 50-yard line for the Chargers, with Stan Humphries taking a very deep drop, setting up a screen. Rodney Culver to the 39-yard line and close to a first down. That's one of those plays that was either going to lose 11 or gain about 11.
Good-looking screen, though. You do it with a little roll to the right, and the Raiders are a pursuing team. They are an attack defense. And they are very smart defense. You get somebody like Swilling off and will drop off into that. This time he was on a full-blown pass rush, set up beautifully, and Culver gets the first down. Beautiful screen.
Nice job by Stan of floating that ball just up and over Swilling. Ralph Friedgen, the offensive coordinator, but Pat looked to me like he was a fraction of an inch away from hitting that ball.
Here's Hayden, the rookie, on first down. And Hayden gets taken down by Anthony Smith and others after a minimal gain.
Well, this is pretty good news for San Diego that they're only trailing 3-0. That they haven't scored in the first quarter is nothing new. So far this year, the Chargers in the first quarter have been outscored 77-35. Obviously, that's by more than a 2-1 margin. And they've made a habit of trailing by more than this at the end of the first quarter. So to have the ball at the very beginning of the second quarter in scoring territory, only down by three, good news for the Chargers.
Got a pass.
Oh, there's a false start. Eric Moten, the left guard, came up early. When you're 310 pounds, it's tough to hide.
False start by the offense, number 77, prior to snap. 5-yard penalty, remains second down.
Boy, Dan, he's made a remarkable recovery from a terrible knee injury a couple of years ago. Maybe not back to 100%, but he certainly has to be commended for coming back from what was a devastating knee injury.
It's inspired his teammates, and you're right. He's probably only about 75% back. That's Carl Mock, the offensive line coach of the San Diego Chargers, and Eric Moten, an extremely popular guy with the Chargers.
Second and 14, that Humphries deep drop results in a completion to the 29-yard line. into the arms of Tony Martin. It'll be third down and five, and let's get an update from Lynn Swann. Lynn?
Thank you. Dennis Gibson went to the locker room. He has a sprained left ankle that is questionable. We don't know whether he's going to come back out for the remainder of this first half or join this team in the second half. But that's all it is at this point. Al?
Okay, thank you, Lynn, as the Chargers have moved down to the 28-yard line, close to a first down.
And we saw Bobby Ross there on the sidelines here in his fourth year in San Diego, and what a team he has in the sense that it's on again, off again. First year they're 11-5, then they go 8-8, then last year back to 11-5, and now on their way to a season where 8-8 doesn't look all that bad. Coming into tonight at 4-7, they've got to run the table to even have a shot at the playoffs, and kind of a football team that drives a coach crazy.
Yep. He's been through the mill too with abdominal surgery just prior to the regular season's beginning, as Hayden takes it inside the 25 to the 23-yard line, tackled by Rob Fredrickson.
And right now it's a team that's really handicapped, quite simply, Frank, just by the loss of Natron Means. You build the club around a power running attack, and when you don't have your power back, you're in trouble.
Bobby Bethard on the left, Alex Banos, the owner, on the right. And all the things that went right for them a year ago, and believe me, everything went right in 11-5 season, and as they worked it through the playoffs, all those things have gone wrong this year.
Second and five. Humphries chased. Smith can't get him, so stand by his time. Everybody's covered, and he steps out of bounds at the 20-yard line. He's short of the first down. Ross is also the kind of guy that he just lets things eat him up. We talked to him before the season began, and I said, how long did it take you to get over the Super Bowl? He said, I'm still ticked off. I haven't stopped thinking about it. I can't.
I bet he's stopped thinking about it now. He's got more problems than just having lost the Super Bowl. This is a football team that, quite frankly, is grossly underperforming. And those are the types of team, you know. Now, Bobby Ross isn't the only coach in the NFL that has one, but it can be frustrating.
Third and three, and the pass is incomplete. He tried to jam it into Alfred Papuno, and Greg Beekert was covering on the play. And in comes the field goal unit. We talked about John Carney with back spasms before the game, but he does come out onto the field to attempt what will be about a 38-yard field goal.
You know, when you talk about underperforming football teams, the AFC seems to be the home of those teams, with the Miami Dolphins, the Cleveland Browns, and the Chargers.
Beeker didn't even look back to the passer, but it got a hand in there. That was a fine play. He didn't know he was going to make that fine play, but he did one.
This is a 39-yard field goal attempt. Gail Gilbert will hold, and Carney, spasms notwithstanding before the game, bangs it through easily. And that ties it. 12 minutes to go in the half. 3-3 San Diego.
Get carried away, darling. It's just a song.
The music of George Strait, brought to you by Bud Light.
Uh-oh, I still have to get gifts for Uncle Bob.
The holidays, it's a wonderful time to lose your mind and go broke. But holiday shopping is easy at Office Max. Hey, it's the Office Products and Christmas Gifts Superstore. There's loads of great stuff, including quality brand names like O'Sullivan or Brother, at guaranteed low prices that will make you quite, you know, joyous. So, shop at Office Max this holiday and save time, money, and very possibly, your sanity. Office Max, we go to the max for you.
If you have what's overall the most powerful line of truck engines on the planet, if you have better resale value than Ford, Chevy, or GMC, if you have what it takes to get J.D. Power & Associates' most appealing pickup award, you're probably not going to put your trucks on sale. But then, if you're Dodge, you like to change the rules. Announcing the first ever Magnum Power sales event with special savings and low lease rates on America's hottest pickups.
The new Dodge.
This Saturday on ABC, three college football games for you, starting at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. The Army-Navy game from Philadelphia. Following that, the battle for the championship of the Southwest Conference, the title on the line there, Texas and Texas A&M. And then in prime time at 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 in the afternoon on the Pacific Coast, the SEC championship game. Can Florida stay unbeaten, setting up their title game against Nebraska in the Fiesta Bowl? Well, they can if they beat Arkansas. It's the Gators and the Razorbacks Saturday night right here on ABC, and that game presented by Dr. Pepper. Carney to kick off, and the Rocket Ismael back to receive the kick. It is taken by Kaufman, who was back there with a rocket at the goal line, and Napoleon is out to the 25-yard line.
I don't think we have to worry about John Carney anymore. That ball is about as far as he can kick one or has ever kicked one, right down to the goal line. He's not a deep kicker. He got every bit of that.
Well, Dennis Gibson is back on the sideline.
I know one thing for sure. If Darren Bennett gets a shot at a field goal, it'll be interesting.
Yes.
30-year-old from Sydney, Australia. I don't wish Carney poorly, but it would be interesting to watch Bennett there in the foreground take a whack at one.
From the 25-yard line, Leslie O'Neill with the sack.
Well, I know that part of the Raiders' game plan tonight was to try to keep a tight end to the left side of the formation as often as possible to help out that guy, Robert Jenkins, with Leslie O'Neill. That's his 9.5 sacks on the year. And that's just a classic end-around move by O'Neill. And even though Jenkins is grabbing his jersey, it's not enough to slow down Leslie O'Neill. What a fine player he is. 10 years in this league and still going strong.
And 102.5 career sacks for number 91. And taken down behind the line of scrimmage, Junior Seau buries Harvey Williams.
Second and long yardage, Vassio. Let's get it together following the sack and go with the draw play. And Junior reading it all the way. That's what the Chargers needed, a little lift to slow down the Raiders' offense.
And they have gotten the crowd here at the Murph. This is a run blitz all the way. That is not a read and react play. That is Junior coming all the way right up the middle, and that's just a case where Dave Adolph guessed right. Dead play from the beginning.
A frequency read, knowing the Raiders' frequency, he sent Junior on the blitz right into the draw.
Third down and 21, 10:40 to go in the half, the game tied 3-3. They have to get to the 35 for a first down, and the pass is in no man's land. Darryl Hobbs, the intended receiver, but he was running straight down the sideline, and the pass well underthrown.
And the Chargers again getting pressure on Vince Evans. He had to release that ball. He would have liked to have taken another beat. He just didn't get it.
And to listen to this crowd here at the Murph, you'd think the Chargers were undefeated. The Oakland Raiders bring out the rivalry here, a long-standing rivalry with the Chargers, and this crowd is into the game.
Gossett to kick, Terrell Fletcher to accept it.
From Wisconsin, gambling, almost lost. He does hold on to the football. It'll be good field position. He takes the shot.
Over the past 3 years, Dodge has offered a choice of more new nameplates than anybody else. Here are three more new choices that make it easier for you to drive an incredibly sophisticated 96 Dodge Stratus. Choose $500 cash savings, or an interest rate as low as 1.9%. Or choose a Stratus lease rate of only $229 per month. The Dodge Buyer's Choice Sale. The choice is all yours at the friendly Dodge dealer near you. Face it, no other razor shaves closer, smoother, safer than Gillette Sensor XL, no matter what kind of skin you have.
almost home.
Thank goodness.
You're exhausted.
How'd you guess?
Quick, what are you going to cook for dinner?
Dinner?
Okay, pick up chicken. Pizza?
Boring.
Tacos?
Tacos!
The new Taco Bell Fiesta family meal.
Cool.
10 tacos or bean burritos, any way you pick. Plus nachos, Bel Grande, and cinnamon twist for four. The Fiesta family meal. Dinner for four, just $7.99. Pick one up when you get Joey from soccer.
Joey? Soccer?
Take a bite out of the new Taco Bell Kids Meal, now featuring Street Sharks. Collect all four. Jawsome.
Rebel, take your creativity to a whole new level.
Express yourself.
With EOS lenses and the Rebel X from Canon.
Crushing jaws, massive muscles. A grizzly nearly ripped this man to shreds. Experience his terrifying tale of survival on Primetime Wednesday.
Working on Dennis Gibson's ankle. Look at this thing.
Thinking the same thing you are, Dan.
They got pads on the side, pads on the bottom. This guy's... They're putting some major support on the left ankle of Dennis Gibson.
You know, if it hurts like I think it hurts, it's not going to matter what they put on there.
He's going to have to get a bigger shoe, I think, with all the different wraps he has on there.
Game time, 3-3, 10:25 to the half. First down, San Diego from the 43-yard line. Humphreys hits the tight end, Dwayne Young, for a gain of about two. Monday Night Football is being brought to you by the new Dodge. We're thinking ahead. Bud Light. If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never lets you down, make it a Bud Light. And Office Max. We go to the max for you.
Outstanding coverage on that last play by Mike Jones.
On Golden Pond. That's me and Dan. No, I mean, it's just...
Our chairs would be a little farther apart than
they better be. One of them would be in the bay. Ronnie Colbert takes it up to the 48.
Never be you, Al. No room service there.
That's right.
It was certainly nice of you to think of me, though. Yes, I appreciate it.
Yes. Ronnie Colbert coming off as Natron Means has a groin pull. If you tuned in late, he was hurt against Miami 3 weeks ago and is now missing his third consecutive start.
But in reality, he missed that entire Miami game as well.
Right. And the catch is made by Sean Jefferson, and he has a first down. Forward progress to the 42 of the Raiders.
Good read by Stan Humphreys. Raiders up front, eight-man front, showing single coverage on the part of Terry McDaniel, and good protection for Stan also. Terry McDaniel had a tough time last week against Michael Irvin. And he plays way off Jefferson. And the Chargers pick up the first down. Good read by Stan Humphreys.
8:35 left first half. Game tied 3-3. Papunu is in motion from the Oakland 42-yard line. Humphreys. Going deep, and incomplete double coverage on the play intended for Tony Martin. Albert Lewis back there covering on the play along with Eddie Anderson.
Pretty good coverage inside out. Albert Lewis on the outside getting help deep from Eddie Anderson. Of course, Tony Martin always the deep threat for the Chargers. He has the speed.
Well, they tried to run a pattern short to get Anderson to bite, and he's too experienced for that. He's not going to have anything to do with that. You try to run an underneath pattern to get that safety to bite on it. Eddie Anderson didn't even take a half a step towards the line of scrimmage. Good play.
Stay on the ground on second and 10 and give it to the rookie Hayden to the 40-yard line for a gain of a couple. Third and 8 upcoming, and here's Lynn Swan.
Al, a lot of things happening here on the sideline. This young man, Charlie Collins, did something pretty special. He just asked this young lady to get married, didn't you, Charlie?
That's right. This is my new fiance. This is Sean.
What, did you have any idea he was going to ask you?
No, I had no idea.
Did you say yes?
Yeah, I said yes.
But were you nervous about doing this?
Oh, man, I need to get up to the bathroom soon.
Well, about 60-plus thousand saw you tonight, and about another 40 million. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Al?
Pleasure to meet you, man.
Where's the ring?
Thank you, Swanee. Only on Monday night, 3rd and 8. Humphreys throws, and a great catch is made at the 30-yard line by Mark Shea. His first reception of the night and a first down.
As we know, that couple will be sitting in your chair, Al, and Dan.
My question is, did they know each other before 30? Did he just see her and say, would you marry me?
Swanee, find out if maybe this was love at first sight. It's love at first sight right here between Stan Humphries, Rob Fredrickson, the Raider in coverage right there, but a beautiful pass downfield to Mark Say. And this is a good-looking Charger drive underway.
Now Hayden Rule for the Tennessee rookie inside the 20, and Ridden down loses the football, and it is...
I think the Raiders have...
They got it, yeah.
Did they get that ball inbounds? We're getting no...
No signal yet from the official, but they're going to say it was... No fumble down at the 15-yard line.
Yeah, well, normally they make that motion pointing to the ground, saying the ball was down here.
He broke a Derek Hoskins tackle, who then stripped it. But he's down. We'll take a look at the replay. He's down. And the recovery was out of bounds anyway. So San Diego with the ball at the 15-yard line, as Hayden picks up 3 to the 12.
One of those deals where the ball was inbounds, but the guy who recovered the ball is out of bounds. That makes the ball out of bounds. The ball itself never left the field, but that's irrelevant.
Meanwhile, lost on all that was Aaron Hayden making a couple of fine moves to pick up that first down. Good, tough running by the rookie from Tennessee.
San Diego is 79 yards to minus 11 for Oakland in the period. Second down and 7 from the 12-yard line. Humphries has to put it down, loses the football, and is lucky to recover it himself. Chester McLaughlin got in there.
Humphries, stop at number 91, Chester McLaughlin.
And that's back to the 22-yard line. It's going to make it third down and 17.
Well, Chester, a Pro Bowler in the middle, and pretty good range for such a big guy, and Stan just barely got that football back. His center, Courtney Hall, in falling across the top of him, almost kneed the ball out of the way where Stan couldn't get it. 7.5 sacks on the year now for McLaughlin. It just seems to get better and better.
Third and 17, and the pass into the arms of Ronnie Harmon. He takes it to the 6-yard line, but he is shy of the first down. They have to get to the 5.
How good a catch was that?
Oh, I'll tell you, he has got great hands coming out of the backfield. He's over 500 career receptions, and that was one of the fine ones. Oh, he's such a clutch player also.
Well, they're looking over toward the bench. They appear to be less than a yard shy of the first down, and they're going to call for the measurement. So they'll bring the sticks in.
Imagine the feeling there, folks, of Ronnie Harmon, who catches that ball going backwards. You might as well have a monstrous bullseye painted on your back right here, because you know you are going to get stuck right in the back. There it comes by Eddie Anderson, and he holds on to the football. That's an admirable piece of work by Ronnie Harmon. And you see the distance they are short.
Tough decision for Bobby Ross against this defense. And
they're going to kick it.
They're going to take the 3. Pretty good move. Put you out front.
Well, I think we see which way Ralph Regan voted. I think Ralph wanted to go for it.
Could also be a long count looking for an offside.
That's one of those deals where all the assistants put in their 2 cents, but
yeah.
The head man makes the decision. It is not a democracy.
And he was frustrated they had come up that short, that half yard shy of a first down. It's a 24-yard field goal attempt for Carney. Gale Gilbert will hold, and he boots it through to give San Diego the lead. 4:38 to the half. It is now San Diego 6, Oakland 3.
Performax 100 Synthetic Motor Oil presents the 100% protection play.
In Super Bowl 21, the Giants' massive and mobile offensive line gave quarterback Phil Simms the ultimate protection. Simms stood tall in the pocket as he completed an amazing 22 of 25 passes in New York's 39-20 victory over the Denver Broncos.
Wow, how'd they do that?
Pennzoil introduces Performax 100, 100% synthetic at a breakthrough price.
100% synthetic at a price this low? How'd they do that?
Leave it to Pennzoil to make synthetic affordable.
How'd they do that?
Hey, there's more. An extra $6 rebate on a case. Or $6 off on an oil change by the pros.
How'd they do that?
Engine problems? Before you try a tune-up, try Gum Out first. The solution could be less than $5.
Let's look at the Magnum Power Sales Event, one word at a time. Magnum, as in Magnum Engines. As in Dodge Dakota Pickup. A little bigger, a lot better. Power. We're talking Dodge. Overall, the most powerful line of truck engines on the planet. Sales. How about up to $3,000 off Dakota? An event? Well, that means this special offer ends sooner than later.
The new Dodge.
The Bears and the Lions are set for a fight. They'll be clawing and scratching here on Monday night.
.438 remaining in the first half in San Diego on a beautiful night. The Chargers on top, 6-3. John Carney has kicked two field goals. Jeff Jaeger one. Full house looking on, a rivalry that started in 1960, the beginning of the American Football League. Oakland against the then Los Angeles Raiders. You've got two teams playing tonight, each of whom have exited Los Angeles. The Chargers did it in 60 and the Raiders last June. And the kick goes into the end zone down there by Kaufman. The Raiders and Vince Evans will take over at the 20 with 4:31 to the half.
There are sure to be a few records set during the 1996 Olympic Games. And as the official airline, Delta has already set one. Of all U.S. airlines, only Delta flies smoke-free on every flight to every city worldwide. It's not something we did to win a gold medal. We did it so you could breathe a little easier. Delta Airlines.
Next is Lady.
Exceptional sheen.
Oh, very good color.
Prince.
Hands.
Oh, such stateliness, such majesty.
Larry. Larry.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
The best of show? More.
Let's look at the Magnum Power Sales Event one word at a time. Magnum, as in Magnum Engines, as in Dodge Ram, ranked most appealing pickup by J.D. Power & Associates. Power, overall the most powerful line of truck engines on the planet. Sales, save on V8s up to $670. Plus, just for California, get air at no extra charge. And event, it's the first time America's hottest pickups have ever been on sale like this.
The new Dodge.
When Diane takes on a dangerous assignment, Bobby gets overprotective.
We back each other up on this job.
Bobby, get out of here.
An all-new Blue, Tuesday, viewer discretion advised.
Gents, lest anyone bury the Chargers prematurely, if the playoffs started today, 1-6-6 team would be in for the AFC. Chargers win tonight, they'd be 5-7. They'd be a game out of the playoffs.
But realistically speaking, though, looking at a situation where they're going to have to run the table. If that eighth loss comes sometime, you know, either tonight or in the next week or so, realistically, I don't think they're going to make it.
Would you guys like to sit together?
No, Frank, huh? We've been in this order for 9 years. Why change now?
From the 20-yard line, Harvey Williams breaks it up to the 31-yard line for a gain of 11. One thing about San Diego, their schedule is pretty soft the rest of the way, beginning with Cleveland in here next week.
It's truly remarkable. In the AFC, there are, only five teams above 500?
Yeah, the one thing, though, for San Diego, though, I think more critical than anything else, is that they have to get Natron Means back in the lineup. And what did Bobby Ross tell us yesterday? That he's not close to being ready, that he still can't run full speed, and this offense is built around this man. And without him, they're just not going to score a lot of points.
You can't hurry, pull the groin. Williams up to the 35-yard line for a gain of 4, making it second down and 6.
talking about poor records with teams playing 500 ball for the regular season, making the playoffs. Cleveland did it in 85 at 8-8. The Saints in 90 were 8-8, and the Jets in 91, 8-8. Those are teams over 16 game seasons in the playoffs.
The amazing thing about Cleveland in 85 with that 8-8, they won the division with that 8-8. They didn't go in as a wild card. They actually won it at 8-8.
Second down and six as Evans throws. Glover makes the catch, has the first down, and he's taken down up at the 44-yard line.
Glover, a huge target for Vince Evans, 6'6", 250 pounds. And he picks up the first down. There he is. Been around now in his fifth year. Real fine athlete. Seems to get better every year.
First and 10 at the 45, 2:43 to go in the first half. Evans, swing pass, Harvey Williams with a stiff arm.
Whoa, and then
out of bounds.
And here we go.
Continues on in front of the San Diego Banks, and the flag comes out.
Harvey Williams had a hold of Dwayne Harper's face mask and drags him to the ground once they're out of bounds. Harvey Williams, in my opinion, is the guy that ought to get the flag right there.
He had the mask when they were out on the field to play.
Yeah, that's.
And he just took him with him. You see it here with the close-up. Is Harvey Williams has his left hand right on the face mask of Dwayne Harper.
That, you're allowed to stiff arm a guy, but not in the face. That should be a penalty all the way on Harvey Williams, and it is.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good piece of officiating. It's bad enough to jam him in the face out on the field, but then to grab his face mask and drag him to the ground, that's an unnecessary penalty by Harvey Williams.
The Raiders last year set an NFL record for most penalties.
There was a personal foul. Face mask by the ball carrier number 22 of the offense. The 15-yard penalty to keep first down.
This year they started out much better in that regard, but they picked up a lot of penalties lately, and in fact came into tonight's game second only to Detroit in penalties.
Momentum back last week against Dallas.
Yes.
For 13.
8.1 penalties per game, so that's two a quarter against the Raiders this season.
Down from last year, what they averaged last year, something over nine.
Mm-hmm.
And there is Al Davis, Mr. Raider himself, in his customary spot in the press box. Not a luxury box kind of guy. Al prefers to sit with the Raiders in the middle of the press box. That goes way back.
Yeah, but he'll take those luxury box receipts. First and 22 as Harvey Williams swings to the outside and gets taken down by Leslie O'Neal.
Well, the Raiders have a fondness for that vertical passing game. They're going to need a little of it just to get a first down here.
We come to the two-minute warning. Chargers 6, Raiders 3.
It's time to wake up, Tommy.
Tommy.
Yeehaw!
Hey, partner, it's time to get up.
Oh, no, here she comes. Tommy, your oatmeal's getting cold.
You asked for it, Tommy.
If you owned the world's easiest computer for multimedia, what would you make with it?
From the producer of Pulp Fiction.
I'm coming to get you, boy. Because I'm your man and you're my man.
Comes the surprise movie of the year.
Finally?
Time says Travolta delivers.
Yeah, what'd he say?
I don't get involved in these matters.
A heartbreaking portrayal.
I can't even make it.
Just do something.
Absolutely electric. Travolta's just terrific.
I promise you, honey, it's gonna be better.
John Travolta, Harry Belafonte, White Man's Burden. Rated R. Starts Friday at theaters everywhere.
I tried a no-name long-distance company because the savings sounded simple, right? Wrong. Bill made me dizzy. Savings? Nothing but restrictions. My work's enough to deal with. Things at home gotta be simple. So I got AT&T True Reach Savings. It's the only way I save 25% on every type of call on my AT&T phone bill, no matter who I call in the U.S.
AT&T True Reach Savings. Save 25% when you spend just $25 a month. AT&T True Reach Savings. That's your true choice. AT&T.
The Goodyear blimp Eagle hovering high above Jack Murphy Stadium, San Diego.
Yeah, I mentioned the Raiders are so proud of their vertical game so far here in the first half. Tim Brown, their leading receiver, no receptions. Ishmael, no receptions. And James Jett. Those are the, that's the speed for the Raiders, and none of them has caught a football tonight.
Inexcusable not to get the ball into the hands of one of the most dangerous threats in the NFL.
Second and 27. The only wideout has caught a ball is Hobbs on a third and six. And here's another toss to a running back, Harvey Williams. Up past the 40. And that's one way to turn your passing game into a vertical game, running after the catch to the 48-yard line, 2 yards shy of the first, and timeout taken by Oakland. Harper made the tackle, and Williams goes hobbling off. 1:45 to the half.
Now, to each man who shaves, there's an edge all his own. Only Edge Gel has 8 custom formulas, from tough beards to sensitive skin, for a close, comfortable shave. Ultimate closeness, ultimate comfort. That's the Edge.
Third and 4 coming up. They work on Harvey Williams. And let's check in with Brent Musburger in New York. Brent?
All right, now coming up on the Lexus Halftime Report. Peter King of Sports Illustrated was in Miami today. He interviewed Don Shula. You'll hear Shula talk about Jimmy Johnson and linebacker Brian Cox. And now you're going to have a live interview with Herman Moore, who's waiting for that at the Silverdome next Monday night. The Lions take on the Chicago Bears here on ABC. Right now, let's send you back to the game and out.
Okay, thank you, Brent. As the Raiders go up to the line, the 49-yard line, third down and 4, Kaufman in the game. And the catch made by Brown, and his first catch of the night is a timely one. It's a first down at the San Diego 40.
Just enough for the first down, and also killing the clock, stepping out of bounds.
I, for one, am kind of anxious to find out what's going on down in Miami. That's really an interesting story with the Dolphins at 6-6 and a Super Bowl favorite, and Don Shula right now is...
off to that great start, 4-0.
Yeah, that's, he's presiding over a certified mess in Miami.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line. Raiders have 2 timeouts left. The pass underneath Brown. So Brown goes the whole half without catching a ball, or most of the half, and then catches them on successive plays. Seau makes the stop.
Boy, it's disappointing to have a team at second and 27 and then allow them to get the first down, especially when you're trying to protect a 3-point lead as the Chargers are now.
Second and 5 at the 35-yard line. 4-man rush, and then he throws it away. Brown, the nearest receiver, covered by Seau. It'll be 3rd and 5 with a minute 13 to play.
Vince Evans making a good play out of that, avoiding the sack, avoiding the interception. Jeff Hostetler on the sidelines looking on.
I think you have to come after Vince, though. I think Dave Adolph defensively has got to come at Vince Evans from a lot of different directions. I know he's been in this league a long time and all that other stuff, but his game experience is still somewhat limited, and I think the more varied you can come after him with blitzes, the more effective you're going to be.
3rd and 5, Brown in motion, Williams back in the game. And Evans buried at the 43 by Glenn Young.
Well, Young and Seau both come on blitzes up the middle. And give Dave Adolph credit there.
Adolph has called a very timely game throughout this entire first half.
There's Greg Strepanek, the right tackle, and he's expressing his displeasure at some of the Chargers. Had a little pushing and shoving going on after that play.
It was a little embarrassing also. They just storm in. Here comes Young, and here comes Seau. No, not enough people.
Vince had no chance whatsoever.
And it takes them completely out of field goal range. Gossett into punt. Fletcher back to receive it. Fair catch called for and made by the rookie at the 10-yard line. The Chargers have all of their timeouts remaining as they'll take over at that spot with 61 seconds to play in the first half.
Ricky Terrell, Fletcher learned quickly the last time he eschewed the fair catch and almost got wiped out. This time, the wave off, the fair catch, and oh, so careful with that thing.
Coming into the game tonight, Fletcher, who's taking the place of the injured Andre Coleman, had fielded two kicks this season, one kickoff and one punt, and fumbled them both.
And if you'll remember, he fumbled the opening kickoff of the game and recovered it himself. For a while there, he was 3 for 3.
Chargers' return game hurt also early in the year with Darian Gordon, who was an outstanding kickoff returner from a year ago and has been unavailable all year.
From the 10 on first down, Chargers keep it on the ground, and Rodney Culver picks up a couple, takes it to the 12.
Now the Raiders are going to take a timeout, and wisely so. This is where the Raiders, having to use one of their timeouts earlier, John Fox, their defensive coordinator, can only stop the clock one more time after this, and that hurts them a little bit. If they could keep the Chargers from getting a first down, they'll get some pretty good field position out of it.
It's a little like a card game right there, because you want to see what the offense is going to do. Are they going to go for it, or are they going to button it up? And when San Diego tipped its hand by buttoning it up, the Raiders figure, hey, we'll take the timeouts.
Fellow we saw strolling on the Raiders sidelines prior to looking at Fox here was one Floyd Peters, one of the more renowned defensive line coaches in the NFL. This guy has been tutoring defensive lines for a long time in this league, and they do one thing and do it effectively, and that is get after the quarterback. Floyd was a fine defensive lineman himself in this league, and he's been an able defensive line coach for decades in the NFL. Good guy. Moderately crazy, but I think you have to be that to be a defensive line coach.
Joe Bugel on the other side, another veteran, another good one for San Diego.
On second and 7, they give the ball to Rodney Culver. He's up to the 16-yard line. And the Raiders will take their final timeout here. The Chargers have a third down and about 4 coming up with 46 seconds. San Diego, well, they can just about run it out. Remember, the clock starts, the play clock, at the end of the play, and it starts at 40. So you run around a little bit, and it takes the officials another second or so to mark it, and they can just about run the clock
out. This is where that lack of the third timeout really hurts the Raiders, because they had a chance to do something. Granted, the Chargers and Bennett have an outstanding punter, but anytime you can put Tim Brown back there to return a punt, you got a chance of making something big happen. This is, if the Raiders do one thing at halftime when they go in to make some adjustments, they better talk about getting the ball to Tim Brown more than they have here in the first half. He has not been utilized whatsoever. Now you got to give Adolph and the Chargers some credit for taking Brown out of it, but by the same token, Mike White has got to talk to his offensive people and say, we must get the ball to Tim Brown more,
a lot more. Third down and 4. And Culver.
At the 20, but he did get the first down. He got the first down.
It's a good thing.
Lucky for him. Very lucky for him.
Well, he was right by the markers, so we'll say that he did know where he was going, but
Hey, rookie. That's one of those, you want to run a sweep there to take those extra 6 seconds off the clock so that the play clock starts when the game clock is under 40. So
if he doesn't get that first down, now he would have had to go onto the Raiders bench.
That would have been unpardonable. Well, maybe they'll launch one here. They've got 41 seconds, and they have a first down, so why not? They changed the whole plan. This is Ronnie Harmon. And Ronnie is up to the 31-yard line, and now San Diego can take a timeout. So it's a funny thing. What's happened here is that they were running the clock out on one hand, and now that they picked up the first down and Oakland's out of timeouts and San Diego has to try to get at least into field goal range.
It's very interesting. They're able to move the ball into field goal range, pick up 3. You could have some interesting hindsight.
And with those 2 timeouts left, what they are afforded the luxury of doing is working the middle of the field. And that means just like what they did right there, clearing everybody out by running deep, going underneath to Harmon, you have the whole field at your disposal.
Mm-hmm.
And from what we've seen of Carney so far, the back spasms haven't seemed to be a factor. He's not only converted a couple of field goals, but he has been putting his kickoffs into the end zone.
Career best, as you see, 54 yards.
Here come the Bolts.
Second and one at the 30. 32 seconds left in the half. Chargers on top, 6-3. Freeze throws, the catch is made underneath at the 35-yard line. That's Omar Ellison, a rookie out of Florida State, and now Humphreys takes a timeout. I think there are better play calls in that situation. 24 seconds left in the first half. Well,
if I'm not wrong, I think that's Omar Ellison's first catch in the National Football League. Mm-hmm.
Tis true.
Seeing his first action tonight, the rookie from Florida State, who was their fifth-round draft choice this year, and he's getting to see some action because of Andre Coleman's injury. The Bears.
The Bears.
The Lions.
Eric Kramer. He'll match up with Scott Mitchell next week at Chicago against Detroit. We'll have a chance to visit with Herman Moore at halftime. Had a fabulous game last
Scott
week.
Scott Mitchell has arrived, hasn't he?
The Silverdome.
But all the other things we talk about in this game, it still boils down to the excitement of watching Barry Sanders run the football.
Next week, Chicago-Detroit.
As good as it gets.
First and 10, 36-yard line. Humphreys guns one, and the catch is made at the 47 of Oakland, and that's Mark Say. And this is out of bounds. Andre Coleman goes over to congratulate him, and it's a first down.
And they save a timeout.
Seconds.
And save a timeout, Al.
They still have one remaining as they try to work their way into range for Kearney, a 17-yard gain.
Exquisite use of the sidelines by Say. Look at him dragging the left foot, has the ball under control. Just beautiful work, and Joe King has no chance to do much of anything.
Humphreys looking, throwing, and the catch is not made at the 34-yard line. Omar Ellison couldn't hang on, 14 ticks left.
But again, here with that one timeout remaining, Stan Humphreys can still use the middle of the field.
And he's sending the receiver, as you saw there. He sent Ellison just to within where it would be within field goal range. Ellison setting up at about the 33 or 34-yard line where Kearney could reach it. Ellison perhaps working back to the ball would have helped a little bit, but he should have caught that football.
Mm-hmm.
It was perfectly delivered by Stan.
Second and 10 at the 47-yard line. Humphreys sets up the screen to the backside. Harmon inside the 35, tackled at the 33. They'll take a timeout and they'll bring Kearney in for about a 50-yard field goal attempt.
Boy, what a nice piece of hustle by Anthony Smith. Pat Swilling, rather. Pat Swilling, who chases that play down from behind. Swilling, the former linebacker with great range, chases Harmon all the way downfield.
So close to 51 yards for Kearney, well within his range.
You're right. They have come a long way, though, from just trying to kill the clock in the shadow of their own goal line.
Yes. They got some help when Oakland called the timeouts on defense. Not a bad move by the Raiders, but the flip side of that is that if the other team gets a first down, then you're in trouble.
And then Culver gets the first down and gets out of bounds.
This drive started at 10. Kearney has made field goals from 39 and 24 and has been booming the kickoffs as well. This year, attempts none from 50 plus. This will be 51 yards. 7-13 in his career from 50 and beyond. Gilbert to put it down. And this 51-yard field goal attempt was long enough, but it was wide. Had the leg, not the accuracy. And the half comes to an end. All field goals on what otherwise has been a very high-scoring weekend in the National Football League. Just a total of 9 points in this one, with the Chargers leading at the half 6-3. We'll return after this message from the NFL and a word from our ABC stations.
He's Jeff Hostetler of the Oakland Raiders.
My wife Vicki and I were in our first year of marriage. Her pregnancy was normal, and then 10 hours after our first son, Jason, was born, the doctors detected a problem in his tiny heart. They told us that Jason had a life-threatening disease. He received the first of four surgeries. A synthetic shunt and a patch were installed in his pulmonary valve. It was touch and go for 10 months. All we could do was wait, hope, and pray.
Ready?
Today, we have two more sons, Justin and Tyler. Both are perfectly healthy. We also have our son, Jason, who is now 10. Our prayers were answered, and our family is together in good health and happiness. But we learned a lot from our personal experience. How would other parents cope with a similar situation? The United Way is there. They support the work of the American Heart Association and serve and counsel the victims of heart disease and their families and the many problems that life can deal out to any one of us. United Way, reaching those who need help, touching us all.
Tuesday, look who's got the blues.
Do the words midlife crisis mean anything to you, Dan?
We're jamming with blues traveler Chase Dan's Blues Away, a special new Roseanne. Dan, it's finally happened. Tony's in love with Melanie's friend.
How about one for the road?
Tony Danza stars in a new Hudson Street.
How about one for the curb?
And Tim proves you don't need class to get a diploma when he's given an honorary degree.
It makes me wonder why I worked so hard for the first one.
A new home improvement.
Here is to higher education.
Followed by a new coach, Tuesday on ABC.
$7,000 off every single new 95 Lincoln Town Car in Continental. And the biggest discount ever on the new Mark 8, $29,988. Only at Perry Lincoln Mercury this week. Your choice of any new 95 Lincoln Town Car or Continental. $7,000 off the MSRP. Or choose a brand new 95 Mark 8. Not $40,000, not $35,000, just $29,988. Every single Lincoln is on sale this week at Perry Lincoln Mercury, just off the La Cumbre Road exit of 101 in Santa Barbara.
Purpose of visiting California.
The cheese.
Welcome. 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 Purpose of visiting California.
Yosemite.
Yep. Step to the right and open your bags.
Look for the real California. It's the cheese.
UCSB DePaul basketball highlights after the game.
The Lexus Halftime Report, brought to you by Lexus Luxury Automobiles, the result of a relentless pursuit of perfection. From our New York studios, your host, Brent Musburger.
Good evening. The spotlight tonight's on the Miami Dolphins, both the good and the bad. Quarterback Dan Marino continued his assault on the record book yesterday with four touchdown passes against Indianapolis. This one to Keith Byers broke Fran Tarkenton's record for touchdown passes. But the Dolphins lost to the Colts. You know, when the season began, the Dolphins were unbeatable. Their fans were dreaming Super Bowl. But they've lost 6 of 8. They're in a dogfight to make the playoffs. Peter King traveled to Miami, where a familiar name is being heard throughout South Florida. Peter?
Brent, the 25-year marriage between Don Shula and the Dolphins in this city is on the rocks. Club owner Wayne Huizenga has spent lavishly and wants to win this year. And because Dan Marino is finishing his 13th year, there's pressure on Huizenga to import Jimmy Johnson and win now. I asked Shula today if he felt the shadow of Johnson lurking over his team.
Well, it's mentioned any time that anything goes wrong, certainly. And, you know, that's something that that wasn't there in previous years. It's there now. It's there in Miami, or if anything happens anywhere else around the country, it's that same specter hanging over it. But that's something that that I have to deal with, and it's something that I'm not going to let influence any decisions that I make career-wise or coaching-wise one way or the other. I have to be concerned about Don Shula and my career and what I've done and what I hope to be able to do.
Peter, last Monday night, everyone saw linebacker Brian Cox ranting and raving on the sideline. More of the same yesterday against the Colts. It seems like the Dolphins are a team out of control.
That's right, and the Dolphins had a clear-the-air team meeting today to discuss that. One of the topics among the players was what I hear from former Dolphins all around the league. There's too many me guys on the Dolphins. There's too much sideline infighting, too. I asked Shula today if his defensive leader, Brian Cox, was one of those over the line.
What you saw with Brian Cox on the sideline is Brian Cox. And when, you know, we knew this about him after he had his rookie year with us, and we made the decision that he was going to be our middle linebacker. He's our defensive team captain. But occasionally when he loses it, he's just tough to deal with. He loses control, and it gets out of hand. And those are things that he isn't very proud of, and I'm not very proud of.
One final irony. 6 years ago, Jerry Jones kicked the coaching legend Tom Landry off of the Dallas Cowboys. Now, because Johnson would demand total coaching and personnel control in Miami, Huizenga would have to divorce Shula to make that happen. I talked to Jimmy today, and believe me, he wants to coach again. He's already talking about a team philosophy that would be light on free agents and heavy on draft picks. Brent?
Peter, insiders tell me that when Shula leaves the Dolphins, the last person he wants to turn the team over to is Jimmy Johnson. Coming up now, the wide receiver who for too long has been overshadowed by Barry Sanders. We'll hear from Herman Moore.
Tonight, the residents of Covington Point will consume 542,000 watt-hours of energy. All generously supplied by a highly efficient new power plant. The incredibly smooth 260 horsepower 1996 LS400. Unthinkable, except by Lexus.
Saturday, ABC Sports combines tradition, history, and excitement in a college football triple-header. First, Army tackles Navy in a high noon showdown. Then, Texas and Texas A&M battle for the Southwest Conference title. And in a primetime matchup, Florida takes on Arkansas in the SEC Championship game presented by Dr. Pepper. It's all Saturday on ABC.
Time now to start thinking seriously about the playoffs. Next Monday night, Detroit, finally in a full run for the playoffs, hosts Chicago. Take a look at the standings, NFC Central. Al, we can see the importance of that game. Both are chasing Green Bay. The Bears have got a big wide receiver they better be ready to deal with.
And, of course, his name is Herman Moore, and he had a big day the other day. Three Detroit receivers, Brent, each had 100 or more yards receiving the other day, Thanksgiving Day, against the Minnesota Vikings, including Herman Moore, who caught 8 passes and now has 87 catches this season. This put Detroit out in front late in the third quarter. They wound up winning the game 44-38. Herman Moore joins us now from Pontiac. Herman, 3 weeks ago, your team is 3-6, and everybody says the Lions are dead. Now 3 wins in a row, you're very much alive. What's made the difference with the Detroit Lions?
Well, right now we're playing with a lot more confidence, a lot more enthusiasm, something that was missing in the games that we lost. Scott Mitchell's having an exceptional year, and our offensive linemen are doing a great job of getting passing lanes and also just opening up holes for Barry Sanders to run in.
Herman, on your team, of course, you're overshadowed by Barry Sanders. And in terms of the wide receivers around the league, the standards are set by people like Jerry Rice and Michael Irvin. And people have said you're just a notch below. Are you now in the same echelon at this point in your career with Jerry and Michael?
Well, you know, we're all used differently in the offensive scheme. So it's really hard to say where you fit where I fit anyway amongst the receivers. But I really try not to get caught up into that. I basically try and go out and perform as best I can for my team. Go out and make plays when my coaches and my teammates expect me to do that. And I let the chips fall where they may. I think that's left up to the national publications, the national media, to determine all those things. But it's more important for me to go out and just play as best I can on every Sunday.
Herman, no coach works a tighter high wire than your man, Wayne Fonts. He's off and on through the years. We have talked to a lot of the Lions through the years. He is a player's coach. Most of the Lions love Fonts, and yet he has been told, in effect, either you get to the playoffs or you're fired. Has that served as some sort of an inspiration for this team in the past couple of weeks?
No, it really hasn't. A lot of people want to think that as a team we're going out and we're playing harder because our coach has his job on the line, but we're really not. We're playing for ourselves. We're going out. Every player has dedicated himself during the offseason to help this team win. So right now is what's most important. We're going out trying to win the ball games for ourselves first and foremost. And Wayne, he really doesn't want a lot of attention drawn to himself for what the team is doing right now, because he knows it's the players that has to get it done. He just wants us to go out and win.
Herman, thank you very much. We'll see you next Monday night.
Thanks, Pat.
And Brent,
It's Chicago and Detroit in the wild and wacky and woolly NFC Central a week from tonight.
Yeah, exactly. You know, Al, Dallas is virtually unbeatable when they play after Thanksgiving. Not so Detroit. As a matter of fact, they're only 24-28-2 lifetime after Thanksgiving. Second half coming up on ABC.
The most affordable Lexus now comes with a moonroof. Six-disc CD auto changer. Leather-trimmed seats. And chrome wheels worthy of a Lexus. And with a savings of up to $2,000, you'll laugh all the way to the bank. The ES300 Luxury Value Package. Available while they last at your Lexus dealer.
The Lexus Halftime Report has been brought to you by Lexus Luxury Automobiles. The result of a relentless pursuit of perfection. We'll be back with the second half kickoff after this from our ABC stations.
Wednesday, it's shocking. It's riveting. Will it finally happen?
Honey, any night with you is special.
Oh, save your sweet talk. You know you're going to get lucky anyway.
Grace, then Nora's parents are grabbing her style.
Look at those pants. How the heck did that happen?
And she gets a little help from a friend.
Not now, Bob.
The Naked Truth. It's an all-new Wednesday.
Sunday at 8, 7 Central, join Jason Alexander, Vanessa Williams, China Phillips, George Wett, and Tyne Daly in the world premiere of Bye Bye Birdie Sunday.
My nephew in California is a venture capitalist.
Yep.
Scary thought, isn't it?
Dear Aunt Pearl, leasing a new Accord LX is the best investment in California. Because I don't tie up a lot of cash, I can be on the lookout for other opportunities. This lease is a gold mine.
Right now, you can lease a new Accord LX for $239 a month for 24 months.
I wonder where he got that investment tip.
Nobody loves their car like a Honda owner.
97.5 KHTY, the new rock revolution. 50 minutes of Santa Barbara's best new rock every hour. Guaranteed. 97.5 KHTY is your official concert station. Featuring World Tour 95. Hooking you up with free tickets to all the sold-out concerts. We've got Santa Barbara's best new rock and killer flashbacks every hour. The party's over here at 97.5 KHTY. The new rock revolution. Listen to it.
Coming up tonight in a special edition of Key News, right after the football game, tragedy strikes over the holiday weekend. Their father, mother, and sister were killed in a three-car accident on Highway 46. Now, two other sisters must pick up the pieces after their terrible loss. And we'll hear from the family of a boy who lost his left arm and leg after being shocked 3 months ago. His road to recovery tonight in Key News, right after the football game. We'll see you then.
Signore,
you make your own chicken Caesar salad, right?
Sure. It's only $8.95 here at Guido's.
I hear it's exactly like Presto Pasta's, and theirs is only $2.49. With romaine and red leaf lettuce, fresh garlic, Romano cheese, homemade croutons, and chunks of tender white meat.
No?
So I know you get yours at Presto Pasta. Guido, you're a bust.
Oh, no. Is this the end of Guido?
Come get the $2.49 chicken Caesar salad at Presto Pasta.
Thanks, you're mentally challenged.
Sign panel tonight.
Starting the third quarter in San Diego with the Chargers on top 6-3, and John Carney to put it in the air. Rocket Ismael and Napoleon Kaufman are back to receive the kick. And this one is angled out of bounds, and that'll put the ball up at the 40-yard line for the Raiders. So Carney, who'd been kicking well tonight despite spending the time before the game on the trainer's table, bangs this one out of bounds. And the 40-yard line is the drive start. Monday Night Football is being brought to you by cold-filtered Miller Genuine Draft, making the world a very cool place. At Magnavox, we make technology people want. Magnavox, smart, very smart. And Visa, official card of the NFL.
Since they changed those rules a couple of years ago, a kickoff going out of bounds is a really rather large mistake. Fabulous field position to start at the 40-yard line just because the kick went out of bounds. A real penalty.
Williams goes nowhere, stopped for a loss of two. Second down and 12. Raiders kind of dominated the first quarter, and then the Chargers turned it around in the second, and the composite numbers look like this.
I think what the Chargers have to be fairly proud of is their defense against the rush. And they have really shut the Raiders down in that category.
Well, especially considering, Frank, the way the game started. First three or four times the Raiders rushed the football, they're averaging about 7 yards a carry, and then whap, they just shut them off completely.
Second and 11. Evans throws over the middle. The catch is made by Darrell Hobbs. He's into Charger territory, tackled at the 46-yard line. Got a nice block from Glover. Bush makes the tackle, first down.
Really a soft little touch there, too, on the part of Vince Evans, who, again, we talked about his ability to go deep, his strong arm, but he just put a nice little touch on this ball and made it very easy for Hobbs across the middle to come up with it.
Of course, if you give Vince that kind of an alley and that type of protection, he's like any other NFL quarterback, will hurt you. No pass rush at all there.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line. All kinds of wackiness in the backfield, and Ismael takes it to the 46 for a gain of about a half yard after all of that. Harper makes the stop.
I think you're right, Al. I don't think they draw it up that way. I think we might have had a pull to the wrong side. If it wasn't, they must have practiced this an awful lot.
And Al, you're one wacky over the limit. You used wacky to describe our Monday night game next week, and now a second wacky. We can't be having any more of this.
It might be a self-description as well.
That's
second down and 10 at the 46-yard line. Just getting us ready for the Pro Bowl. And that throw is behind the intended receiver, James Jett. Third down. Let's get a word from Lynn Swan.
Al just answered some questions about the 281s in this ball game. Tim Brown. Mike White said he felt he could run the ball, so Tim Brown was intentionally not a part of the game plan in the first half, but he says he will put the ball in his hands in the second half. Now with Tony Martin, he has a bruised cornea, got that in the first half. He is not coming back into this ball game. He is out for the rest of the day, Al.
So Tony Martin, the wide out for San Diego, is gone. Natron Means gone with the groin pull. Missing a couple of very key people offensively. Third down and 10, Evans throws, and the catch is made at the 40-yard line by the Rocket. And he's off to the races and gets hog-tied at the 26-yard line by Seau.
Yeah, that's a brutal tackle, and it might have saved six on the part of Seau.
Closing
out of the coverage, coming back. And it was a clothesline shot. But it could have saved six. Take a look again. Coming out of the coverage, avoiding the face mask, avoiding the penalty. Good reaction on the part of Seau.
First down at the 26-yard line. Kaufman in the game. Here's Napoleon, the Washington rookie, to the 20-yard line for a pickup of six. Tackled by Gordon and Shaw.
Oh, he is excited. He can really accelerate. He can take it to the sideline, spin it back to the inside as good as I've seen coming to this league.
Boy, you love a rookie that walks back to the huddle with a smile on his face, don't you?
He loves it. He wants to play it. He can do it all, too. He's a tough little blocker.
Well, this is the type of the time of the year where rookies hit the wall. They've already played so many more games than a normal college season. Kaufman is impressing Mike White by getting stronger as the year goes along. Highly unusual.
Second and four. And the intended receiver not even looking.
That was Kaufman.
Pass was coming in. Kaufman.
Harper plays this brilliantly. Ties up. Kaufman coming out of the backfield. Steps in front. Gets the interception. Terrific play by Harper.
Black & Decker presents How Would You Fix It?
My name is David Deacon Jones, and I'm the guy who invented the term sack the quarterback. And tonight, only three sacks have occurred on a 40-year-old man. Now, I don't have nothing to say about that, because I'm over 50, but I'm thinking about coming out of retirement. So send your cards and letters, ladies and gentlemen, because tonight the pads are not rattling. Both of these teams need a win, and they're going to have to hit a little bit harder and score some more points.
True perfectionists never cut corners. However, they will, on occasion, have to sand them. Introducing the VersaPak Cordless Detail Sander from Black & Decker. It's how things get done. This isn't just any sport utility vehicle. It's the first one from a luxury car maker. With heated seats, retractable mirrors, and power moonroof. The new Acura SLX. It's the most civilized way to leave civilization.
What the hell are we gonna do? Go faster!
Wesley, Woody.
Charlie, when this is over with, remind me to knock you out.
They're back. In the funniest thrill ride of the holiday season, Money Train, rated R, at theaters now.
Tuesday, Hayden can't believe his eyes.
Doris and Luther.
What do you mean?
Don't make me say it.
Or his ears.
Why don't you join us?
A new coach, Tuesday.
Everybody on the Raider sideline trying to explain to Napoleon Kaufman that was a pass play, not a running play. And it helps if you look for the ball.
Humphreys from the 11-yard line drops back and hits Mark Say for a first down up at the 23-yard line.
Let's go back and take a look at that play by Napoleon Kaufman. He starts it as a running back. Here he is right here. Here is Harper here, who just goes back and sits into his zone coverage. But Napoleon Kaufman never turns around. He just looks like he's going out to block Harper as if it's a running play. And when he came over to the bench, virtually every offensive Raider came up to him and tried to encourage him by not, you know, don't get your dauber down.
Harper's second pick of the season. Humphreys from the 23 floats one incomplete. And he'll be looking a lot more for Say with Tony Martin out of the game with that scratched cornea. And here's what happened. Go back to the first half, and we'll see the play that knocks Tony Martin out of the game tonight. James Trapp covering on the play. Right there.
Right there, coming off the line of scrimmage.
Boy, completely inadvertent by Trapp, but nonetheless, you could see the instant effect that it had on Tony Martin. And that's a large loss for the Chargers, who are already without Andre Coleman.
Blitz on second and 10, and Ronnie Harmon is tackled immediately, making the stop on the play was Mike Jones.
Martin really takes the stretch out of the San Diego passing attack. He represents the speed to the outside, the deep threat, and as you mentioned, Dan, with Andre Coleman unavailable, that's about it for the speed on the outside.
This is... again, an offensive team. There's Coleman on the sideline. And again, minus their biggest offensive threat, Natron Means. So a severely handicapped offense for the Chargers.
Third and 11. Humphreys to Harmon. Ronnie looking for that first down, and he's right there at the stick. Run out by James Trapp, and I believe he's got it.
So why not go to the only real legitimate threat that you have left on your offensive team, and that's Ronnie Harmon.
What a great sense of where he is anytime he's on the football field. Timed that up beautifully, stepped across the first down marker. How many times over the years have we watched Ronnie Harmon do this? 10-year veteran, first with Buffalo, and been coming here as a plan B player in 1990. They love to use him out of the backfield, particularly on third down.
On the 34-yard line, flag is down. Aaron Hayden, the rookie from Tennessee, picks up a yard. And the clock stops with 9:51 to go in the third quarter. Chargers leading 6-3.
6-3, Chargers, Raiders, third quarter. That just doesn't seem to ring right.
Well, this weekend of unbelievable scores around the league.
Motion against San Diego. Ed Hockley is the referee. This is the only game this month in which there was no touchdown in the first half. Only game in the entire NFL.
Illegal motion by the offense, number 86. The penalty is declined. Brings up second down.
Of course, when these two played the first game of the season, it was a relatively low-scoring game. A Raider win 17-7.
There it is, the points this season, weeks 1 through 10, 41.3, and then they really picked it up. And they've gone over the 50 mark this week. Say makes the catch. And he's up to the 45-yard line. Albert Lewis makes the tackle, and that'll move the chains. And points per game over any one weekend since 1970. Week 7 of 83, 54.4. In 1987, week 6, 52.6. And coming into tonight's game, 51.5. There it is, right up there in the top five since 1970.
I don't think we're going to pad that tonight, though.
Not to this point. Here's Hayden up to the 48-yard line. And you might say that those in the league office are overjoyed.
Well, it's what they like. The rules have been changed. Al, you're not going to draw me into this.
There. Of course I am.
I understand exactly what you're saying. The thing about the league, though, they have changed the rules. They have modified it. The fans love more and more scoring, and that's what we're seeing. It's excitement.
And second and seven. Hayden gets bumped down as he crosses the line of scrimmage by Fredrickson, but he takes the ball into Oakland territory.
And you talk about those rules changes and what it's done, and the ratio of pass to run has also been almost as remarkable as the increase in scoring. Passing so much more, of course, so many teams using, you hate to even say it again, the West Coast offense, the short passing game in lieu of the running game. I think that represents most of it, but the pass run ratio heavily weighted on the pass side.
In fact, out of every 100 plays, 57 are passes, 43 are runs. A pass here to Ronnie Harmon, and another San Diego first down out of bounds at the Raider 37-yard line.
You know that Ronnie Harmon is going to handle the ball a lot in the second half, given the injuries to this Charger offense. That time the responsibility to cover him goes to Rob Fredrickson, their number one draft choice of a year ago. And you see Harmon with the move inside, then back to the outside. Spins Fredrickson all the way around, and that is a matchup that even though Fredrickson moves well and is a good cover man, Harmon's going to win the vast majority of the time.
7.5 minutes left in the third quarter. Chargers on top by 3. Here's Rodney Culver running into Fredrickson as he crosses the 35-yard line. Gain of about 3.
Given his choice, Ronnie Harmon would like to stay in the football game, not just come in on a passing situation. It's kind of irked him. He is a very quiet individual. We mentioned a great athlete and a great team player. But he's been shaken up just a little bit. By the fact that he's not used more extensively, and particularly since Natron Means is gone. Just bothered him.
Second and 7 is Culver, picks up a couple to the 32-yard line. McLaughlin makes the tackle. And that's the 11th play of this drive. The Oakland drive was a good one to begin the quarter, but then the pickoff by Harper. And now the Chargers countering as they try to extend their lead.
Boy, you accomplish so many things putting together a drive like this. Eat up the clock, you protect your lead, moving into scoring position, and you're keeping this explosive Raider offense. You're making spectators out of them over on their own sideline.
Fletcher and Harmon are the running backs. It's third down and 6. Jefferson in motion, and the catch is made by Ronnie Harmon. Another first down to the 21-yard line.
The Raiders are being harmonized here.
It's 3 consecutive third down completions for first downs to Ronnie Harmon. I would call that a frequency. One that the Raiders had better correct.
Well, there's so much motion in this Charger offense. Virtually every play, either the H-back, Papunu, or Young is in motion. Harmon, again, acting like he's going outside, just finds a hole in the zone of the Raiders. And if they sit back in that zone, Harmon's going to chew them up.
Hayden to the 19-yard line. 5:20 remaining third quarter. The Goodyear blimp Eagle on a sparkling Southern California late November evening, hovering above Jack Murphy Stadium.
See, type of weather here in San Diego that Every time we come here, I wonder why the entire world doesn't live here. If San Diego doesn't have perfect weather, I don't know where they have it, but it's not here.
Second and seven. Catch is made by Jefferson at the 16-yard line, and Albert Lewis makes the tackle right there.
Yes, in my ear, Kenny Wolf, our producer, offers up Honolulu as a,
yes.
as another choice. You're right. That's
right,
pretty close to perfect.
Segue right to a Pro Bowl promo. We'll be there on Sunday, February 4th. Came back from your favorite place, Maui, Al. Kathy and Reed's doing their show over there, and they all send you their regards, particularly from your luxury quarters where you like to vacation.
La Casa de Saint.
Third and five at the 16-yard line.
A truly shameless telecast.
Absolutely.
Truly.
And we're just getting underway. Humphreys throws, and that's a first down. Jefferson to the 7-yard line.
There was a laser-guided missile by Stan Humphreys. Is Stan hurt? He sure is. Something's wrong with the right leg.
McLaughlin came in to knock him down.
He's going to have to check out, too.
Unless they want to take a timeout, Gilbert will have to come in to quarterback a play. If they want to take a timeout, well, Stan's in the huddle. The play clock ticking down to 15.
Is that Chester McLaughlin coming in from the backside? Yeah, that's Chester.
He just fell on that right foot.
A little awkwardly, he comes down on top of Stan.
Oh, and the Raiders had to call timeout.
Yeah.
This is a break for San Diego and Stan Humphreys.
McLaughlin called the timeout. Carl Mott working up a lather.
Unique, with an inner fire and an irresistible natural beauty. There's no mistaking a brilliance that lasts forever. This Christmas, surprise her with a diamond beyond all her expectations.
For 1996, we redesigned everything. For a new style, a new spirit. Not because we want to be the best thing on the road, but rather, the best thing in the air. The employee owners of Trans World Airlines, we're up to something good. Cold-filtered Miller Genuine Draft. The cold one. You know the beer, you know the taste. With Miller Genuine Draft, the world's a very cool place.
ABC's NFL Monday Night Football. Brought to you by the NASDAQ Stock Market, the stock market for the next 100 years. The NASDAQ Composite Index closed today at 1,029.32, down 0.85.
The Raiders had to take a timeout as San Diego has a first and goal at the 7-yard line. Ronnie Harmon in motion. Humphreys is 7 of 8 on this drive and nearly gets sacked, tries to get it away, and he was in the grasp and controlled, and he is sacked, in fact, at the 16 by Nolan Harrison. We talked about Harrison before, hurt much of the season, back tonight. And the reason the Raiders took a timeout a moment ago defensively,
I think
here it is.
Pretty good awareness by Chester McLaughlin, who's right here. He realizes that Mark Say is out here with nobody on him. There's Albert Lewis coming out late, but McLaughlin had already called the timeout, realizing that nobody was out there on a wide receiver. I think that's a pretty good presence of mind there by Chester McLaughlin.
He was screaming and yelling at Humphreys.
Big sack, though, by Harrison.
Second and goal at the 14. They set up a backside screen to Culver, who avoids a Jones tackle, then gets taken down by Beekert at the 17-yard line. It will be third and goal with 2:45 to go in the third quarter, and the Chargers on top 6-3.
The Raiders have been sucked into that screen on a couple of occasions. This time they played it beautifully, and
Anthony Smith
in pain, holding his right arm or shoulder.
Well, it's something involving the right arm or shoulder.
They played that screen beautifully.
Raiders this season, only two touchdown drives against them of 80 or more yards. Tied with the 49ers, fewest in the league. This drive began at the 11-yard line. A 9-minute drive, and they're trying to make it pay off here. But it's third and goal from the 17-yard line. Ellison in motion. Say makes the catch. He is inside the 10, but not much further. Anderson makes the tackle, and Carney will come in to try to tack on three more.
Well, that shortens it up considerably. Interesting play. Kind of a one-man screen to the outside. And it just about sprung Say for the distance. Watch, it goes out to Say. And watch Harmon with the block in front of him. Andre Bluse, the Raider with the hands up, almost deflected the ball. But a saving tackle at the 10.
28-yard field goal attempt for Carney. Gil Gilbert puts it down, and the kick is perfect. So all field goals in the game tonight, three off that man's foot. 1:22 left in the third, 9-3 Chargers.
Once a single library held the knowledge of the world. Centuries later, data was still controlled by an elite few. Then Oracle freed everyone to work with databases. Today, Oracle is putting the knowledge of the world online.
It will forever change our markets and our culture.
Where do you find companies whose future is as limitless as our hunger to know? Actually, there's a list of them printed every day. NASDAQ, the stock market for the next 100 years.
$6.
Harry.
Yeah?
How come you're charging me for the hot dogs?
The 52-inch Magnavox big screen TV with smart screen and a picture so good you can charge for the hot dogs. Smart. Very smart. Now get a pair of wireless speakers free when you purchase a Magnavox big screen TV.
Apollo 13 flight controllers, give me a go, no go for launch. Booster.
Go.
Retro.
Go.
Network.
Go.
Recovery.
Go.
We are go for launch.
Apollo 13, a Ron Howard film, available on video cassette for $22.98.
Face it, no other razor shaves closer, smoother, safer than Gillette Sensor XL, no matter what kind of skin you have.
When Diane takes on a dangerous assignment, Bobby gets overprotective.
We back each other up on this job.
Bobby, get out of here.
An all-new Blue, Tuesday, viewer discretion advised.
That's the primetime lineup Wednesday here on ABC. Ellen, the Drew Carey Show, Grace Under Fire. The Naked Truth will come your way, and primetime live to wrap up the evening, Wednesday.
Well, we're live in prime time right now, and the naked truth is that was one heck of a drive by the San Diego Chargers. It only netted 3 points, but 19 plays. That is just about as long as it gets.
So 10 minutes and 1 second off the clock, and that's fumbled and has to be run out by the Rocket, who runs parallel along the 10 and turns it into a decent run back. But he fielded it as the flag comes down in front of the goal line, then fumbled it back over the goal line and had to come out with it. Ed Hockley says holding against Oakland after all that.
So many times when you bobble a kickoff, that's when you get a big return, and Rocket just about
holding
broke that
by one. The receiving team on the return. The 10-yard penalty, first down.
But they're going to back it up.
And so the Raiders begin deep in their own territory with 1:09 left in the third, and the Chargers up by 6.
just any sport utility vehicle. It's the first one from a luxury car maker. With heated seats, retractable mirrors, and power moonroof. The new Acura SLX. It's the most civilized way to leave civilization.
Business is about as predictable as the weather. You never know when a storm's going to hit. But for those unpredictable problems...
And you need it when?
UPS has solutions so predictable, they're guaranteed. From same-day service in as little as 4 hours to overnight delivery as early as 8 a.m. Plus, guaranteed 2 and 3 day services. Whenever you want it there, wherever in the world you want it.
We're back in business.
Nobody offers as many on-time options as UPS. Nobody.
Miller Genuine Draft. America's cold-filtered beer. As cold as they come, as smooth as it gets. A beer uniquely cold-filtered for maximum refreshment and a quality all its own. Miller Genuine Draft. For those who've discovered its smooth draft taste, the world is a very cool place.
The Florida Gators take on Arkansas with bowl bids on the line. It's the SEC Championship game presented by Dr. Pepper Saturday on ABC's College Football.
In honor of Junior Seau.
In honor of Dan.
What is that?
Bowl of fish.
Yeah. First down for the Raiders from the 11-yard line. From the 11-yard line, Vince Evans, the quarterback, and movement, flag.
Number 22, Harvey Williams, the ball carrier, penalty flag on the field.
This crowd here at Jack Murphy Stadium, it's fun to see a crowd get behind a ball club that's three games below 500 right now, but they love their defending AFC champions here in Southern California.
5 yard penalty.
And you hear this crowd down as they exhort their defense on. They're acting like a crowd that's rooting behind a division leader, much less the division basement dweller.
Well, they brought an awful lot of thrills last year to these win-hungry Charger fans by going 11-5, and even though they got beat in the Super Bowl, they got there in a very exciting fashion.
Listen to this.
First and 5 from the 16-yard line. Harvey Williams picks up a couple, and another flag comes in at the end.
Harvey Williams,
whatever it was, very obvious. Probably a face mask. 4 flags flying right where the contact was made.
Might be Seau here.
Personal foul, face mask by the defense, number 55. A 15-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
Ooh, and that'll let Oakland out of deep trouble.
Junior arguing his case, but that's certainly to no avail after the fact. No question he has it. Does he let go of it?
Mm-hmm.
Well, he did let go of it.
But he turned that head, Dan. They see that.
That's real borderline as to whether that's a 5-yarder or a 15. Normally, you got to drag that guy down to get the full 15.
Looks more like the garden varieties. Evans has it picked off. It's Harper. His second interception of the night. He grabbed the shirt of Shaw, who was blocking out in front. And he's taken out of bounds at the 31-yard line.
He's riding Terrence Shaw like Fuzzy Thurston. looks like Jim Taylor following Thurston around the corner.
One that Evans should have never let go is right into the zone coverage and right into the hands of Harper. He had to seam on the little rollout. Goes right into the hands of Harper.
Hey, there are more presents to open.
Okay, Dad.
The Compact Rosario.
Has it changed your life yet?
The human face. Difficult terrain. Perfect for Braun's new three-stage shaving system. One foil removes short hairs. An integrated cutter, longer hairs. The second foil completes the job. For Braun's closest shave yet.
With my itchy dandruff, I said I'd try it. Denerex tingles. Head and Shoulders doesn't.
Both have effective dandruff medicine, but Denerex has something extra that tingles, feels fresh.
That's why I started using Denerex. The flakes, the itch, gone.
Denerex, the serious dandruff shampoo.
There's no stealing your thunder. Can't be contained. Fill me with wonder. Cool me off like rain. That's the heart of me. Dr. Pepper, you're a part of me.
Whoa. Cool. Mom,
what did I used to do after school? Well, we used to watch a lot of TV.
Bye.
Good question.
The Compact Presario. Has it changed your life yet?
Think things aren't competitive in this league. Watch Harper as he goes out of bounds. He's well out of bounds. Watch from the left. Right here, Vince Evans comes up and gives him a little chin music with his left forearm. I think a little anger there at being picked off.
That was after Jerry Ball started to give him a forearm with his right arm.
Well, you could understand Ball doing it. He's a defensive lineman. Those guys are supposed to be mean and ornery and take shots at those guys.
Not when you're in a suit.
I can't tell if he's wearing shoulder pads or not.
Flag down prior to the snap.
Please reset the clock to 11 seconds.
Must be Jerry Ball's left shoulder that's troubling him. He's very active with that right arm.
Meanwhile, Harper, a longtime Seahawk, coming into tonight's game, Harper had faced the Raiders 15 different times with one interception. He has two tonight alone.
And that's six for the season overall for... Excuse me. That's his second.
Good look there. Jeff Hostetler trying to pump up Evans.
Here's Humphreys. And the catch is made by Hayden, who is out of bounds at the 35-yard line. And the clock will tick down. This is the first game this season in the National Football League, game number 180, in which no touchdowns have been scored by either team through three quarters. End of 3-9-3 San Diego. Monday Night Football resumes after this from our ABC station.
Finally, a show that puts the world of the unexplained to the test. Get the scientific facts on ghosts, mediums, and psychics put to the test. Then, the commish is back in an all-new two-hour movie.
He did not kill Tom Bell.
In hours, the wrong man will be executed.
The state is going to send me into hell.
Unless Tony catches the real killer.
We've been looking at this all wrong.
Dean Stockwell guests on an all-new commish in the Shadow of the Gallows. It's an all-new Thursday here on ABC.
When I was growing up in Missouri, everybody used to tell me, Doreen, you're so pretty and perky. Like those ladies that sell plastic wrap on TV.
But your doomed disappointment in St. Joe, you're just not gonna find here.
Not in KC either, not even in St. Louis. I said, Doreen, you gotta pick yourself up and just go on out to California, go to Hollywood. Go to Hollywood. So I did, and you know what? They were right. Cheese is a lot better here.
Look for the real California. It's the cheese.
The young boy nearly electrocuted 3 months ago is now back home. We'll take you on his road to recovery tonight in a special edition of Key News right after the football game.
John Pomentary checks out who makes what Wednesday on Key News at 11.
Back in San Diego, the fourth quarter begins. Al Michaels, Frank Gifford, Dan Dierdorf, and Lynn Swan. 9-3 Chargers. As the Chargers have it at the Oakland 34-yard line, it is second and 11. Freeze trying to get it into Shea, and it's incomplete. McDaniel covering on the plate. Third and 11.
McDaniel getting a lot of help from the inside. Mike Jones and Humphreys tried to force that in there. Very dangerous.
Well, we talked about the Chargers. Don't count them out yet. A victory tonight would make them 5-7. The rest of their schedule, Cleveland here, Arizona here, at Indianapolis, at the Giants. Not that tough. Third and 11 at the 35-yard line. Humphreys nearly sacked, stays on his feet, nearly sacked again, and then they had the opportunity for the hat trick and made it pay off. Anthony Smith sacks him at the 50.
And that is a monster sack. Close to 15 yards on the loss, and Frank?
It doesn't mean a whole lot, though, because Humphrey very wisely didn't throw it up for grabs, and they're still in midfield where they're going to punt, and they should be able to kick the ball well within the 20-yard line. This is very smart by Humphrey. Just don't put it up for grabs. He'll lose a lot of yardage, but they're still in midfield for the punt.
Give the Raiders a lot of credit at the start of that possession. It looked like at the very worst, the Chargers were going to get a field goal try on it.
Flagged down back at the feet of Brown, which came out early. The punt by Bennett. Brown's out of bounds at the 9-yard line.
That flag came so early.
Very interesting call. That flag was thrown.
Well, it's either
Brown's
that they didn't get the playoff in time or that there were too many men on the field, because that's back where they count heads.
That was against the Raiders. Well, that's the preliminary indication.
A holding call against.
It was a hold on the way out of the huddle.
It was a holding call called from a long way away.
The official called it with binoculars.
Well, again, if this is holding, this is going to be an automatic first down if it was prior to the kick.
Holding by the receiving team, number 37, during the kick. A 10-yard penalty. Half the distance to the goal and close from the foul. Oakland will keep the ball, first down.
Okay.
It had to be so obvious, and it was.
Yeah. Right. The key there that it happened after the ball was kicked, that is not an automatic first down. That's just a loss of yardage. Raiders will have the football.
I used to hear the old guys talk about history and the cars they made. Didn't mean much to me then. I had missed those years. But now I think about how they felt when it was happening. We were called an experiment. You see, what someone figured out is that there's something more important than machinery and equipment if you want to get a good product out the door. It's about people. Their struggle to do something they've always wanted to do, but never had the chance. No time clock, no foreman, just you telling yourself what to do. And if you have 8,000 people making the right decisions individually with the company and the car in mind, then you have 8,000 people that own that car. And every car that goes out, that's the way I feel.
Introducing the MGD Wide Neck. 16 ounces of cold filtered Miller Genuine Draft. In a bigger bottle with a new wider neck. Which should make getting to its smooth draft taste even easier. Now that ought to float your boat.
It sounds good instead of traditional daycare, your kids in a warm, private home. But our hidden cameras captured scenes you won't believe. Primetime, Wednesday.
Well, the good news for the Chargers is that the official saw the hold. It happens right here. The bad news is I want you to watch Bennett kick the ball. The hold comes prior to him kicking. There's the hold, and it's prior to Bennett kicking the ball. The Chargers should have retained possession of the football. The official saw the hold, but it clearly happened before Bennett kicked the ball. That should have been an automatic first down for San Diego. Mm-hmm.
The official was way downfield when he made that call. It was so obvious because Trapp actually flipped the Charger.
You can look at that from either side, depending on who you're rooting for. San Diego gets jobbed, or the Raiders dodge a huge bullet. Take your pick.
It was both. Williams had game three on the first down play, and now Harvey through the middle for a big first down, and a lot more, and he's out in front. Harvey Williams into San Diego territory, and caught from behind by Harper to save a touchdown.
And right now, if you're the Chargers, you're thinking to yourself, I've been jobbed badly. On a play where you should still have possession of the football, the Raiders come up with the big play.
And one of the knocks on Harvey Williams was, when he was with Kansas City, was that he was very hesitant in looking for the hole. Watch the explosion here, however. He gets a great block from Gogan, number 66, gets a huge block from Derek Finner. There's no hesitancy here. And Harvey Williams with a great burst, and a touchdown is saved by Dwayne Harper.
Gets another block downfield by Jett.
Here is Kaufman. He is tackled by Gordon. That's a 60-yard run by Harvey Williams. It's the longest run of his career. And
Skrepanek still down on the ground. Well, it's tough to block a play any better than the Raiders did on that long run by Harvey Williams. Junior Seau reads it, takes on the block by Fenner, but he's a spectator on this long run.
Visa, the world's number one card, presents number one. This receiver has the ability to turn any play into a big play, and he holds the record for most 200-yard receiving games. Who is the NFL's number one deep threat?
Recently, the Broncos and 49ers showcased their talents in Tokyo.
Love is a many splendored thing.
At Zone West Karaoke.
By your man.
Blame it on the bossa nova. The dance of love.
Where the players brought no ability to carry a tune, but did bring their Visa card.
Was it the moon?
Because Zone West can accept just about anything. Except American Express.
Everybody sing. It's the April rose that only...
Give it off and take it to the corner. You'll lose him. You'll lose him.
Lance Allworth lost a lot of defenders. Bambi was as graceful as his nickname. Five times he caught passes for over 200 yards to become pro football's number one deep threat.
Believe it or not, with Hewlett-Packard's real-life imaging system, the print quality of HP's new DeskJet 600 series printers is so good that your work might just take on a life of its own. HP Home Printers. Just what you had in mind.
Chicago needs to bear down to stay in the playoff hunt, while Detroit and Barry Sanders aren't lying down yet. Next week on ABC's Monday Night Football.
San Diego on top, 9-3. Harvey Williams, though, has reeled off a 60-yarder to put the Raiders into Charger territory at the 34-yard line, second and 11. We saw Greg Skrepanek hurt on the last play. He was helped off. Russell Freeman takes his spot at right tackle. A swing pass to Williams, and he's tackled by Dwayne Harper in the open field. Harper having a big night.
Having a big year. Harper's played great corner for the San Diego Chargers. He moved over to the left corner this year after working on the right corner last year. Longtime starter for Seattle. Came last year as a free agent. He makes a good play.
Yeah, we asked, does he look at Skrepanek, Bobby Ross, last night, who's playing real well for your team? And Harper was one of the first guys off his lips. Third down and nine at the 32-yard line. Here comes the blitz. Evans stays in the pocket, throws, and the catch is made at the 20-yard line by Tim Brown for a first down. First down, Oakland. Monday Night Football is being brought to you by Saturn, a different kind of company, a different kind of car. Delta Airlines, you love the way we fly. UPS, moving at the speed of business. And Microsoft, where do you want to go today?
Well, that was a big-time throw by Vince Evans to Tim Brown, USC, to Notre Dame.
But that Just Brown's third catch of the ball game, I believe. And you're right, a big time throw by Evans, who had a guy right in his chest.
Williams cuts it back. Nice move taken down by the rookie Shaw as he works his way inside the 15. Gain of five.
Well, Harvey Williams is having a superb year. I mean, that just in good instinctive running. He could have strung that out, maybe gained a yard. As it is, he gets three or four out of it. But he's been making plays like that all year long, averaging over 4.5 yards a carry. Quite a bit more now after that 60-yarder.
Second and five at the 14. Williams. Close to a first down. Wayne Gordon makes the tackle. He's a little short of it.
Kind of a statement there by the Raiders that here we come. Tim Brown over on the sideline. Only one receiver in the ball game. A two tight end formation and an eye set. That's an obvious signal that here we come. We're running the ball. We're coming straight at you. We dare you to stop it.
They're going to measure. They appear to be inches short of the first. So it's going to be, it should be third down at about a half a yard, which officially is third and one. And in these situations, the Raiders have excelled this season.
Lead the league, do they not?
Yep, they are the best in the league at converting in these opportunities.
And in contrast, the Chargers have been very weak in defending third and short.
Talk about all your tools, but when you convert at over 70% on third and one, the guys who deserve the credit are your offensive linemen. They're the guys that make it happen.
They're 15 of 18 in these situations. Third down, half a yard to go, 10 minutes left in regulation, 9-3 San Diego.
Craig Janoff gives us the shot of the right guys. Steve Wisniewski, the all-pro left guard.
Double tight end set. Williams, first down, to the eight, first and goal, Oakland.
Just padded that percentage, didn't they?
Mm-hmm.
Relatively easily.
16 of 19 now. League average in those situations is 70%. This drive began back at the 4-yard line.
It's been that kind of night, a multiple play drive. We've seen a 10-minute drive with, 18 plays?
Harvey Williams, meanwhile, 100 yards tonight. Quietly and efficiently and effectively. 18 carries, triple figures. Trying to add to it. Instead, he loses about a half yard. Wayne Gordon first to hit him.
Harvey Williams heading towards a 1,000-yard season. He's well over 900 now. And we have a Charger down.
It is Reuben Davis. Raiders have not had a 1,000-yard rusher since 1985, Marcus Allen.
Is that his year for, about 1,700?
Yeah, that's the year he set the record for most yards from scrimmage, rushing and receiving.
Boy, and here's one of the guys who is a certified run stopper for the Chargers, Reuben Davis. His 320 pounds clogs up the middle, and boy, they'd hate to lose him.
Uh-oh, I still have to get gifts for Uncle Bob.
The holidays, it's a wonderful time to lose your mind and go broke. But holiday shopping is easy at Office Max. Hey, it's the Office Products and Christmas Gifts Superstore. There's loads of great stuff, including quality brand names like Packard Bell or Gemini, at guaranteed low prices that will make you quite, joyous. So, shop at Office Max this holiday and save time, money, and very possibly, your sanity. Office Max, we go to the max for you.
Get on your Pontiac and drive, drive, drive.
Did you ever dream of driving in a Grand Prix? The sound of a 215-horsepower, 24-valve engine roaring to life. The hold of the four-wheel independent suspension yearning for the next turn. The sense of control from a cockpit designed for driving. Then you know why the Pontiac Grand Prix is named Grand Prix.
We are driving excitement, Pontiac.
Oh. Miller Genuine Draft, the cold one. You know the beer, you know the taste. With Miller Genuine Draft, the world's a very cool place.
Wednesday, the boss promotes Drew.
Don't give me away to anybody.
Oh, you little devil!
Or is it a proposition?
Word has it you're sweating to the oldies.
It's an all-new Drew Wednesday.
As close as it gets, 260 to 260 in total yardage. It is second down and goal, 9-3 San Diego. Second and goal just inside the 9-yard line. As Vince Evans on a roll throws off balance and is batted away by Harper. Glover wants a flag and doesn't get one. Harper playing it very tight on Glover. Harper got all tangled up with Glover.
And Harper's hurt.
And he is hurt. He limped away from out of the end zone and then settled back. Could just be putting the shoe back on, but he was limping. Harper having some night.
And that is incidental contact. It appears that their legs and just, feet got intertwined.
It's just great play. He absolutely had great position.
Good non-call.
Third down goal from the 8. 8:26 left in the fourth. And time called. Some stuff is coming out of the end zone. That might have something to do with it. Well, too much
play clock had run out.
But I think they are going to factor into what was being thrown onto the field.
There will be no foul charge on the play. A beach ball was thrown on the field. So the clock will be reset to 25.
Ooh, Bobby.
And I'll ask the fans to please stop throwing objects onto the field. Thank you.
So a beach ball had been thrown out into the end zone.
We just caught a shot there of somebody throwing a towel.
That really hurt the Chargers because they did not have time to get that play off. That would have been a 5-yard penalty. And now it's third down and goal. Evans, quick drop, batted away at the 1-yard line, Bo Orlando. Darrell Hobbs was the intended receiver. In comes Jaeger to try for 3. Orlando and Sean Gale brought in by Bobby Bethard after they had problems with their secondary tackling a year ago. Remember the Super Bowl? They treated Jerry Rice like a national treasure. They didn't want to touch him. And Bo Orlando makes a big play.
Boy, did they tighten things up when they had to. Boy, just the kind of defensive stand you like to see out of a team. Stiffening when they have to. Well done, San Diego.
26-yard field goal. And Jaeger converts for the second time tonight. He made a 30-yarder in the first quarter on Oakland's first drive of the game. They add 3. The Chargers lead 9-6 with 8:18 left in the fourth.
In your passion for performance sedans, you look to Europe and you pay a painful price. Now there's a new 240-horsepower Pontiac Bonneville. So precise, so responsive, it hardwires your impulses directly to the road. All at a price thousands less than you were prepared to pay. The new Pontiac Bonneville. It makes your passion painless, but no less intense.
We'll be in New York tonight. Changes?
Okay.
Il veut faire des changements.
Okay.
Okay.
Add back the slides in the middle.
Réintègre les pages PowerPoint à la présentation.
No problem, okay.
Move the forecast to section 2.
No problem.
Statistics to the back.
We're on the internet.
Excuse me. We downloaded the new forecast. We have the files right here.
Yes. Yes,
I've got it. Business just fascinating.
Everything's in order. Okay. See you in New York.
Au revoir.
My father always said, remember, son,
To make it to the 1996 Olympic Games in Atlanta, you need determination, perseverance, and an iron will. Then he forgets the one blooming thing you really need.
Ah! I forgot your Visa card!
Visa. The only card accepted at the Olympic Games.
That was my dad, wasn't it?
It's everywhere you want to be.
You see all the green cheese, huh? Moon over San Diego. The baying of the hounds in the background. Post-Halloween treat for you. Jeff Jaeger to kick off. 9-6. The Chargers on top. Terrell Fletcher back to receive for San Diego. Fletcher at the 3-yard line behind a phalanx of blockers, but busting through on the outside was Jones. The backup running back Calvin Jones out of Nebraska coming in from the side to stop him back at the 18-yard line. Stan Humphries averaging about 7.5 yards per attempt tonight.
And from a percentage standpoint, 23 out of 30 works. But the end zone has been elusive for both clubs.
First down from the 18-yard line. Humphries throws, and it's batted down by Albert Lewis, the longtime chief, 11 years there, 2 years now with the Raiders. Bats it down.
That's a pretty nonchalant coverage by Albert, isn't it? That's making it look too easy. One of the great corners ever to play this game, Albert Lewis. Look at this. That's,
he's not really terrified of Say's speed either.
That's called smothering the receiver.
And it's called knowing your receiver. Well played.
Second and 10 at the 18-yard line. Aaron Hayden up to the 20. There'll be third and 8. A flag is dropped.
Harry Swain, the left tackle for the Chargers. If holding wasn't on him, it happened close by.
And it will be a holding call against San Diego.
Ooh, what a frustrating year for Bobby Ross. You can hear it in his voice. You can see it in his eyes. All the things that went right a year ago.
Holding by the offense, number 72. Half the distance to the goal. Repeat second down.
Harry Swain. But all the things that went right a year ago just didn't happen this year. It's been a very frustrating year. The penalties coming at the wrong time. The turnovers. They've had a tough year.
I don't, you know, a win tonight will go some other way to help correct some of that. You know, if they can run the table, they'll probably make the playoffs. They'll get themselves to 9-7. They'll do a lot of damage along the way. And you mentioned their soft schedule. They're capable of doing it.
Second and 19. Say makes the catch, and he is taken down by McDaniel up to the 20-yard line. No team will admit they have a soft schedule, but when you look at games against Cleveland and at the New York Giants and at Indianapolis, even though the Colts are playing, you know, pretty well at this particular point, all things considered, San Diego, if they can get hot, could very well wind up 9-7.
And Natron Means still out. We don't know about Tony Martin. We saw him go out with what they described as a bruised cornea. I mean, that could be a lasting injury, or rather injury for them.
Third down and 7 now as Humphries throws, and Harmon drops it. Big drop.
Best was thinking about the run before he looked it into the hands.
Boy, was he open.
Who knows it better?
That is an absolutely routine pickup for the Chargers and Ronnie Harmon, and that's a rarity.
Oh, he has such good hands. He's such a fine athlete. Just takes his eyes off the ball, looking for running room instead of looking it into the hands.
The ball a little bit behind Harmon, but you just don't see that when it hits him in the hands.
Bennett fielded at the 40 by Tim Brown. He brings it back to the 47-yard line. And Vince Evans in the offense takes over at that spot. Golf coming your way Sunday. Shell's Wonderful World of Golf, Sunday at 2:30 Eastern Time, 1:30 Pacific.
Jack Nicklaus and Tom Watson meeting there, and then the JCPenney Golf Classic, where the stars of the men's and ladies tour pair up, and that event all Sunday, Golf Sunday, right here on ABC.
6 minutes and 57 seconds left in this ballgame, and you wonder to yourself, can we go the balance of this ballgame with Tim Brown being as small a factor in this ballgame as he has been to this point?
He's caught three balls tonight. This is Oakland's best starting field position. That's tipped and incomplete, intended for Derek Fenner. I think it might have been Mims who got a hand on it.
If it is Mims, he has been having some night tonight. He has been pressuring Evans. He's batted a couple of balls. He has had a fine night of work tonight against the Raiders. Vince on a slight rollout to his right. He moves so well, and it is Chris Mims. And as you can see there, Derek Fenner was extremely open.
Second and 10 at the 46-yard line. Kaufman in as the running back. Napoleon takes the toss. And he is taken down by Leslie O'Neal.
Well, one for the other corner. Yep. Now O'Neal makes a play from his corner.
Well, maybe they better try the middle.
Bottom of your screen, Leslie O'Neal came up a first-round draft pick in 86, almost had a career-ending knee injury in his second year. Took him a couple years to get back, and still one of the best around.
Third down, 17 from the 40-yard line. 6:12, and the clock running left in the fourth. Evans, pressure, backside pressure, sack, loses the football, and it is Chris Mims who comes up with the ball. San Diego has it.
Three big plays from the corner for the Chargers. A nightmare for Vince Evans.
A good look at it from behind. There is Seau on the blitz. He forces Evans out of the pocket, and then it's Mims coming from the backside. Vince had that ball hanging low with in his right hand. Look at that. Evans never got a chance to put it away, and Mims took it out of his hands. That ball never even touched the ground. That's an extremely alert play by Chris Mims, just taking it away from Vince Evans.
From the 27 now, Hayden. Inside the 25, takes it to the 22-yard line. Mike Jones makes the tackle. Chargers would like to use as much of the clock as they can right now. The smiling Seau and the defense doing its job. 5:48 and ticking down left in the fourth.
Well, a defensive team that I think was really challenged this week, and look how they have responded and how they have stymied the Raiders here in the second half. Interception, interception, a field goal, and a fumble. Three turnovers in four possessions.
Second and five from the 23-yard line. Hayden inside the 20 to the 19-yard line, setting up a third and two. Eddie Anderson makes the tackle.
When the Raiders came into tonight, plus eight in the takeaway giveaway ratio, and they have been hurt tonight.
You know, this team was embarrassed last week in Denver when they're tied up 27-27, and Denver moves in for the game-winning field goal by running the football seven consecutive times. Terrell Davis never even had to have John Elway throw the football. That humiliated the Chargers, and their defensive team has certainly responded tonight.
Third down and a deuce from the 19-yard line. Humphrey starts to stumble, and then Hayden falls down in the backfield. So a double trip, and it's fourth down, and in will come Carney.
Well, deep penetration there by McLaughlin, and Hayden tried to break it away from McLaughlin, and he slipped and fell.
That is a wonderful illustration of the difference in this Charger offense when they're having to give the ball to a rookie in this situation instead of Natron Means. First of all, Humphreys almost fell down coming back out from under center, and then Hayden did fall down.
38-yard field goal attempt for Carney. Gilbert puts it down, and Carney bangs it through. With 4:02 remaining, that's the sixth field goal
of the game. Four of them by Carney, two of them by Jaeger, 12-6.
Yeah, but a touchdown and an extra point by the Raiders puts them in the lead. So the Chargers still clinging to a lead that is less than a touchdown.
The Raiders have been the kings of Monday night through the years, but not this year. In fact, it's been a Monday malaise for their offense. They've played almost two full games and have not scored a touchdown. Shut out in Denver, two field goals tonight.
27-0 by Denver, and nothing happened tonight. With all the explosion they have, with all the speed on the outside, unable to generate a big one.
Talk about an explosion. There is a big one. They shoot that cannon off here. I know this crowd at Jack Murphy Stadium has become accustomed to it, but for those of us that here periodically.
The first one gets you, doesn't it?
I wouldn't be standing in front of that thing.
I'm from New York.
This guy's trusting to be standing in front of the barrel there when he's flossing it.
See, you've served a lot in the military.
That's right. Floss your barrel. Nice pants, too, while we're on.
They don't distinguish between a field goal and a touchdown with that baby.
That guy's going to line it up.
Is you in his sights in a minute, Dan.
They shift that off for safety. Here's Carney. Into the end zone for the touchback. So the Raiders will take over the 20. We began the telecast by telling you Jeff Hostetler wanted to play. He's as tough as they come. He thought he could have played. He wanted to start. He wanted to suit up. There he is, but Mike White talked to him this week, and he said, no, you are not. Not tonight. Let's get a word from Lynn Swan. Lynn?
Al, there are five generations of the Sousa family who have been firing off this cannon. And the youngest member just came out here, fired it off. They're kind of handing off the duties, I take it, here this evening. So they will continue as a family to continue to fire the cannon and then floss after each firing.
See, I was right.
Here's Evans from the 20-yard line, throwing incomplete, intended for Tim Brown, who looks around for a flag. Junior Seau among those covering on
well,
the
Well, there is a flag, but it's back in the pocket. Yeah, it's back in the pocket.
That might illustrate why they're not going to Brown too much tonight, too. He was in a pocket of defenders, double coverage all the way on Tim Brown. Evans trying to force it in.
Holding by the offense, number 64, 10-yard penalty, the two first down.
By the Raiders, again victimized by their own hand, and I mean that literally, as holding is called on the Raiders. Robert Jenkins, the left tackle. Because he is the left tackle, he will be on the left side of our screen there. Number 64, working against the great Leslie O'Neill, who gets that rip, and Jenkins forced to hold him and take him down. That's just where a quality player draws the penalty by his own excellence.
The other tackle, Strepanak, who's been in and out of late, is out right now. Russell Freeman in at the other tackle spot as Evans unloads for Hobbs, and he makes the catch. He threaded it in there. Beautiful throw. Great catch. First down at the 40-yard line.
Well, what a great touch. After you've thrown a couple of interceptions, you kind of hesitate to throw into this kind of coverage, but Vince Evans threw that absolutely beautifully between Bo Orlando, the safety, coming over to help out the rookie Terrence Shaw, and just put it in there perfectly. Watch this. It couldn't be any better. Right over Terrence Shaw and in front of Orlando. Beautifully thrown. First down at the 40, 3:41 left in regulation. Williams knocked down after a gain of one by Sean Lee. Army Williams. Mike White, coached at Cal, coached at Illinois for a number of years. Very honest guy. He says, you know, I stayed at those places too long. I tend to wear people out.
Actually, coached here 4 years before he finally became the head coach. 59 years old. First job as a head pro in the NFL. Evans on second and nine, throws, and the catch is made by Kerry Cash. No, they say. The head linesman right there to say he juggled and never had possession. Junior Seau said, that's the right call, man.
Well, one of the things the Raiders aren't doing is wearing out the end zone on Monday Night Football. You know, we had them against the Raiders, I mean against the Broncos, excuse me, in Denver, where they got pitched a shutout by the Bronco defense, beaten 27-0. And now tonight they've only managed 6 points. Pretty good effort there to catch the football one-handed, but obviously not in control.
Vince Evans finished that game as Hostetler got hit in the throat against the Denver Broncos. Third down and 9. Time, nope, time. Whistle had blown. The play clock was down to 0.
That's one way to stop the play. Ed Hockley steps right in front of Vince Evans.
By the offense, the 5-yard penalty. It remains third down.
Well, this crowd was making noise before that play. May have had some effect on Vince Evans. Whatever the decibel level was, it's going to get higher this time. A lot higher. There, that's really high.
Third and 14 from the 36. 2:58 left in regulation. 12-6 San Diego. Evans under pressure throws. The catch is made by Harvey Williams. Harper makes the tackle, but well short of the first down. Chris Mims put the pressure on. They are about 7 yards short of the first. Fourth down and 7. The clock is running. 2:35 left in regulation. They have 2 timeouts left as we look ahead, plus the 2-minute warning.
Well, Chris Mims is playing one heck of a football game.
He's killing Russ Freeman.
Yep. And remember, Freeman's filling in. Skrepanek is out. The normal starting right tackle for the Raiders, Greg Skrepanek, sitting this one out here as he was injured earlier. But Chris Mims has been all over Vince Evans all night.
Timeout San Diego. They wanted to make sure they had the right people on the field. It's one of those options here for the Raiders. It's 4th and 7. You've got 2:20 left in the game. You're going to get 2 opportunities to stop the clock on your own, plus the 2-minute warning.
Evans turning right in to Chris Mims. Bobby Ross herding the cattle, and finally he realizes he's going to have to call timeout.
He had the defensive unit on the field and getting them off and the return unit on.
Could there be a coach in the NFL who doesn't have some sort of a stomach disorder?
No, there can't be.
I don't know how it's possible. How could you coach in this league and not have perennial ulcer problems? Mm-hmm. Not to mention walking into your defensive lineman.
Well, Bobby's had him. He had the intestine, the abdominal surgery before the season.
Well, what a year. You go 11-5, you go to the Super Bowl, you come back, you win. You know, get up to a good start. You win 3 out of your first 4, and then roof falls in. You lose 6 out of 7.
Now, after that timeout by San Diego, the Raiders, and they said, again, they had the option, so now they're going to go for it on 4th and 7, or at least line up to go for it. Evans. And it is knocked down. Tim Brown, the intended receiver, Bo Orlando, was there with the coverage. So they turn it over on downs, but they'll have the opportunity, if San Diego doesn't get at least 1 first down, to get the ball back with a good amount of time remaining.
Orlando with a second big play here in the second half. Former Houston Oilers starter Bobby Bethard, picked up as a free agent, makes a superb play. Evans with plenty of time, looking for his main man, Brown, and a terrific playboy, Bo Orlando. Little double coverage there, as you can see. Harper on the outside, Orlando on the end.
At the 43-yard line. The Raiders figure to take an immediate timeout here after Hayden gets tackled by Hoskins, and he does, and they take a timeout. That's 1. They'll get 1 more in 9 seconds at the 2-minute warning, and then have to take their final 1. It was 4th and 7. They went for it. Bobby Bethard, the general manager, down on the field. Yes, sir. Says the 58-year-old Bethard, who spent an hour and a half surfing off his home in Leucadia this morning.
But, you know, that's the way most of us work out our frustration, right? Go hanging 10.
The great Bobby. Oh. He's built some winners over the years. You think back to the Miami Dolphins in the early days when he was learning his trade down there. And then, of course, what he did for the Washington Redskins over the years that he spent there. And it took him 5 years to get the Chargers into the Super Bowl a year ago. He's one of the best in the business.
Well, this game tonight, if, in fact, San Diego should win, is an admirable one indeed for the Chargers, who needed to play well and needed a win desperately. Let's be realistic. It's more or less a speed bump for the Raiders on their way to the playoffs. They will be in the playoffs and quite frankly, have as good a shot of getting to the Super Bowl as any team in the AFC. And many people think they're the most talented team in the AFC. But if the Chargers should win this, very commendable indeed.
Second down and 10. Hayden swings to the outside. Smith makes the tackle. He takes it to the 39-yard line. It will be third down and 5, and now the clock stops at the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to go. San Diego up by a half dozen.
So in this equation, what is the slope of the curve?
At -2.3, the slope is 9.
Correct.
That's his 10th completion in a row.
Man, he's got skills.
He knows what he's doing.
He's got some challenge.
Well, here we go, here we go.
Hey, this kid never fumbles. Just check this out.
Put it together, man. He's putting it all together.
A smooth move.
50 players from the National Football League have recently proven themselves big fans of education.
Man, is he fast.
Together with NFL charities, these players have given a $1 million gift to the college fund.
Check it out.
Their strong show of leadership sends a message to young people that education is essential, that brains need developing as well as bodies. Thanks to their support, deserving kids will have the chance to achieve greatness.
Oh, he's unstoppable.
These NFL players agree. A mind is a terrible thing to waste. Join them and support the College Fund.
Minutes to go, third and 5. If the Chargers hold on to win it, they'd be 5-7. We talked about the rest of their schedule. Cleveland and Arizona here, then at Indianapolis and at the Giants to wrap it up. Those four teams with a composite record of 18-30.
And Dan talked about tonight being a road bump for the Raiders, but they got a pretty tough schedule. They go home and play Kansas City, then they have Pittsburgh at home, and they go up to Seattle and they close out at, against Denver. Not an easy road ahead for the Raiders, but clearly, if not the class of the AFCs, they're certainly right up there.
San Diego can, in effect, close this game out with a first down. Otherwise, the Raiders can take a timeout, and they will get the ball back. Third down and 5 from the 38. That compels Humphreys to throw, and the pass is incomplete. Intended for Ronnie Harmon. Stan goes down in a heap, and it's fourth down.
Ooh. He, again, is going to have to limp off.
Well, remember, he hurt his leg in the first half when Chester McLaughlin fell on him kind of awkwardly. Might have been Nolan Harrison that time. And downfield, the coverage was provided by Albert Lewis. Let's watch it. Yeah, he took a shot. Took a shot on the front of his knee by Harrison.
McLaughlin fell on right foot.
I'm not so sure it wasn't the blow from the front that hyperextended it a little bit.
Well, it's fourth down. That's the best of all possible worlds for Oakland on that play because they save their one remaining timeout. They'll have 1:56 on their clock.
You're right. That's the risk of putting that ball in the air.
Yep, and one timeout left.
That was a chancy call by Ralph Regan.
Now Bennett to punt. Brown lets it float down. It bounces at the 2-yard line and takes a good San Diego hop, and they'll down it inside the 5.
Well, at first glance, I thought that Bennett hit that ball too hard. that it was going to carry into the end zone, but like that Bellotta ball with a sand wedge, plunk, right there.
Oh, and on the sidelines, we look at Stan Humphries grabbing at his right knee. And that's the natural surface for you. Bennett doing it just the way Greg Norman, his countryman, would do it with that sand wedge.
Are we going to call him the punting shark?
Yes. Well, Greg's done it a few more times than Bennett, who just discovered this game a couple of years ago and really didn't kick seriously until a year ago last May.
Well, the daunting task now for Oakland is to go 96 yards in a minute and 45 seconds. They have one timeout left. Evans launches it, and out in front was Ismail. At least he was out in front of Willie Clark. The double coverage was coming over in the form of Sean Gale at second down.
Yeah, but Sean Gale, in my estimation, would have been late getting there. Sean Gale, who has the deep outside to that side, would not have been a factor if that ball was a little better thrown. That would have been a completed pass.
Mm-hmm.
You have got to get your safety there a little quicker than that. Gale might have got the hit in later, but he wasn't there in time to break it up.
Second and 10. Vince throws. Williams makes the catch. He gets up to the 10-yard line, tackled by Young. Third down and 5.
Boy, an offensive lineman's biggest fear, guys, is having to pass protect in the end zone. It just runs chills up and down your spine knowing if you get called for a hold that it's a safety. Big play to get those guys out of the end zone.
Third and 5 from the 10. Four-man rush. The pass is nearly picked off by Shaw. Fourth down, flag down.
Flag down, though, late.
Flag at the 21-yard line. And it's against San Diego. That's going to be a first down.
Pass interference by the defense. Automatic first down.
Terrence Shaw, I believe, gets the call. He just reached around. It looked like he just reached around Hobbs, and he's the one that draws the flag. Looked like pretty good coverage to me. Let's take a look. Tough call.
Well, like they couldn't possibly have called Shaw, could they?
First down at the 18-yard line. And that's a little high and incomplete, nearly picked off. Brown looks around for a flag. Sale almost had the deflection. Second down. Go back and take a look at the play again, the interference.
Apparently they are ruling that Shaw had his left arm around Darrell Hobbs. It looked like a real fine play to me. Let's see. There it is. No, there it is. It actually was a holding call, but it would have been more appropriate.
Yeah, it's prior to his play on the ball.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we didn't see it the first time around. That's good work by the officiating crew.
It is. Second down and 10 from the 18. 63 seconds to go and one timeout for Oakland. Evans has it picked off. Harper again. 3 tonight for Harper.
Boy, a season rolled into one night for Dwayne Harper, who, you're right, Al, you mentioned it earlier when we asked Bobby Ross who's playing well, said Dwayne Harper might be our most consistent defensive player.
And another one that should not have been thrown by Vince Evans. He knows it better than anyone else.
4 turnovers tonight for Oakland. The 3 picks by Harper and a fumble.
6 DBs in. Harper steps right in front of Tim Brown, and that perhaps is why they have not been going to Brown. He's been drawing double coverage all night long. Evans tries to force it in and gets the pickoff.
Well, congratulations to the Chargers. This has to feel mighty fine.
Humphries with a kneel down.
Way to go to our crew tonight guys. This was a wonderful look at a football game.
Mm-hmm.
Best crew in the business. Well done.
Terrific. Dwayne Harper, he's been facing the Raiders for 8 years as a Seahawk for most of his career. 16 games against them. Had one pick through 15 and 3 tonight. Off the 40-year-old Vince Evans, Jack O'Hara, our executive producer, the great Wolfman, father-to-be Ken Wolf, producing the game. so beautifully directed by Craig Janoff. Joe Schavo at the controls at the switcher. And the gang, Ben Harvey and the whole gang, Jaime Bravo and company, moving to Pontiac, Michigan. Next week, it'll be the Detroit Lions against the Chicago Bears. Steve Hurd, our director of information, the gang upstairs, Andrea Bryant, George Hill, Malibu Kelly Hayes, and away we go to Pontiac for Chicago against Detroit next week. Oakland took a timeout, their final one. And two more kneel downs will end the game.
Pretty exciting ball game to not have had a touchdown scored.
Have we decided? Is this the first game of the year without a touchdown?
This is the, I believe, yes, it's the first game of the year without a touchdown.
Hard to believe one could be as exciting as this one without a touchdown.
Last game without a touchdown over a year ago, the Cardinals and the Eagles, November 20th of 94. And so the Chargers stay alive. Little smile across the face of Bobby Ross. They go to 5-7. Cleveland comes here. Oakland goes to 8-4. They'll go home to face Kansas City. And that's it from Jack Murphy Stadium. John Carney, who was being massaged before the game and was questionable. It would have been Bennett kicking. Instead, Carney comes off the table, kicks four field.